I want to welcome you all to House of Reawakening Minds on this Friday, October 6, 2017. And our instructor for tonight is none other than Grand Chief Taj Tariq Bey. Let's welcome him.
Glad to be here, House of Reawakening Minds, and remind you all, thank Dr. Naila for maintaining the integrity of the House. About 205, 206, I did a lecture in Connecticut about the dangers of the UCCs. Now, I'm going to run through it real quick because I don't want to get distracted, because I want to stay kind of focused because of our time, because I want you to be effective. In other words, one of the major things that I try to do, because, like, for myself, you know, I always look at it as a fault, but it's what I've always been from a child. I've always looked at things on multiple levels. And as I grew up, I thought that's how everybody saw things. You know, so I had to learn. For a while, I suppressed it. You know, as I got older, I don't care what they think. You know, that you're out to lunch or something type thing. You know, but like, if, as an example, as a child, I have a book or paper like this, you know, what I would do, I'd go in it and come from the backside and I'd look out because almost like it's, the letters are floating. You know, and that was my, you know, like this children do, you know. Mm-hmm. Some children have imaginary friends. That's how I read it. But to me, I could always like go into the time period to where it was written, and I could take on the spirit of whoever wrote it. And I could also see what they were trying to say and what they didn't have the courage to say. Mm. And I would say that part for fun. Until, as I was growing up, and I started recognizing that it made people uncomfortable. And so I suppressed it. You know, you start thinking something's wrong with you. You understand, right?
Yeah, sure.
But I always looked at things that way. So when I look at things, I always look at things like with almost like seven eyes or something like that. In other words, I don't see like this. I see it's sort of like, it's kind of weird, but that's how I look.
Oh, yeah, that works.
You know, really, actually. And after a while, as I traveled, you know, getting in different organizations as I grew up and stuff like that, in very short order, I would always get in trouble because I wouldn't go for the bullshit. Well, I mean, I could see through things.
Yeah.
And so, and the other thing I recognized, I usually advanced very quickly in the organization. They put me in a position of power. And after a while, I recognized, after a few years, a lot of different organizations, they was trying to shut me up. That's why I founded the round table, so I don't have to be under their jurisdiction. But I can still communicate with them, but I don't do well being a follower guy, going on stuff that I can see through.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I can, like, what I used to do when I was seven and a half, stuff like that, because I started writing when I was young, very young. I had my library when I was seven and a half. If I would always, like, if I looked at something, or if I saw, and if only when something that I'm really interested in, if I'm not really focused on it, doesn't make a difference, but if something I'm focused on, I could go ahead and look back, and then come back, and then play chess type thing. You know, and for some of you read some of my stuff, that's why my books are out of sequence. That's why lesson books are out of sequence. It has more to do with leader guys than it does with the people. So if you recognize that, because sometimes people say, well, lesson book 4 or 5, they're deliberately missing. They're not missing, they're just not pushed out. Otherwise spoken from them. So that y'all can understand how I think, so I don't offend you sometimes. Because I don't want to, you know, offend you. But I also want to try to encourage you to look at things with multiple eyes at the same time. So I try to express it, but I, you know, So I'm telling you where I'm coming from so that you can kind of be bear with me, because I could be a pain in the butt in another level, you know. Anyway, now the UCCs, keep this in mind, and this is a synopsis real quick. Uniform commercial codes didn't become uniform until around 66 to 68. And it had to do more with particularly representatives of Texas area, the Republic, not going along with the operations that took place in 1861 with the Congress adjourning and sealing the deal. And the Congress for the United States actually secretly setting up a kingship oligarchy for themselves, and then retaking the seats and operating as if they're the legitimate Congress for the United States, the Republic, which they actually overthrew. That's essentially the contemporary politics that North America is rooted right there. Are we clear? Now, anybody that's a political scientist knows that. Any politician knows that. Anybody in your higher degrees of masonry, any of those orders, already know that. The only people that don't know that is the general masses, are we clear? Many and most Europeans know it who have basic education. Most of the Europeans who are not aware of it, but do have access to it, though they may not be aware of it, or like some of the poorer Europeans that live in the poorer communities. They're not unaware of it, they're not focused on it. If need be, all they need to do is step up and they will be protected. Do you understand? You understand? All right, so, which means don't take it that as we're talking about these things that people don't know this stuff just because it's not in conversation. It's in operation. Are we clear?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So first, get that through your head. All right. Now, you know, when we've given the people over the years of judicial proclamation papers and a name correction, in law, those papers are really, really an adverse claim. Are we clear? An adverse claim, and the reason why I say think, because when I did those papers over in around 1989, 90 in that area, shortly after that, at a multi-state conference, they elected me a member of the Order of the Great Seal in New York, and registered in the Library of Congress. You know, that's where I got the title of Mir from, with the Order of the Great Seal. And whenever somebody came into the order, basically someone who was conscious would present them as a candidate, they would make sure they had all their tools. And then they would have an honor period, they would give them bylaws and everything, synopsis of the history. But they would also have already had a background in basic scholarship of an MSTLB degree before they could be entered to the order. They already had to have MSTLB degree. It's not how we always operate, but basically that's the rule. Are we clear? Because it's essentially a privy council. Are we clear? Even though information is not necessarily hidden, I mean, it's not something that's hidden, we don't hide it, but for people to comprehend what they're really dealing with. Because most people have no idea of the real politics on Earth planet. And this is only a layer of the onion. Do you understand? A lot of what we do here, and a lot of what I've done over the years, is really preparing people for another jump that comes after this. But this has to be in place to protect them from other injuries that are already being prepared for them, that they may not be aware of, or clear. So I'm being honest with you, and I'm saying that to you because I already know that other people who are also conscious also want to feed you out. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? And because the Romans are accelerating the conversion of estates, while people are asleep, they don't know that overnight they can be totally insecure. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Yes.
So I'm appealing to what you know about yourself. I'm appealing to what you've learned from a childhood to this time, and for you to be thinking on all of those levels and start putting things together that we may not discuss. Meaning that you've got to be able to think in layers. All right? That's not a loaded statement. So don't try to look at it as a loaded statement. It's a direct frontal statement. All right? Because you're going to need to be able to get to that level to survive. Economically, absolutely, and greatly potentially physically. All right? Because that's where things are headed, whether you know it or not. All right? So I'm not going to burn you on that, but I'm just telling you ahead of time. You know? So why I focus on certain things? Because the dark priesthood have had centuries to set this stuff up. So they're kind of locked in. And they work on layers. See, they work on layers. This is what you have to understand. This is why people can't beat them. Because they work, they operate on layers. So I'm telling these things as a prerequisite. Because in truth, in your memory cells, you already know this. So I don't want to have to try to explain everything, just putting certain prerequisites up there. All right? But because of the cycle that we're in right now, because the timing is why I'm emphasizing this. It's nothing that I haven't said before, but I'm just, it's sort of like a nail, a special nail I'm trying to put in their coffin. Back then, yeah. All right. Now, so the proclamation papers, judicial notice, they are actually briefs and affidavits. They are actually adverse claims. But the particular subject matter of the adverse claim is because they are liquidating people's shelters, because they're accelerating the unum sanctum wars. And that is under the dead pledge. And most people don't know what the dead pledge is. The dead pledge is a mortgage. Mortgage means dead pledge. Any property that you think you own, but you don't own, you're really sharecropping. And this is what, you know, I understand about the dark priesthood. They know that most people don't know that if they don't have an adverse claim already running, they can exercise what they've been doing to people all over this country. Gentrify their estate and make claim, whether they're so-called thinking they're paid up or not. They'll just tag the ones that ain't giving them gifts no more. They'll call it non-payments when it was really paid for as soon as you put your monograph on. All right? Now, over the years, as people learned some of these things about the global estate trust that the Pope set up after the fall of the Red House, they've been using different methodologies trying to get what you call jurisdictional claim or control over the estates. They've about 35 years ago, they used HMOs, then they used site drafts, then they used affidavits to transportation departments, then they used commercial code processes with UCC, financial statements, 3 and 9, stuff like that. And now it's the birth certificate. But understand that all those different processes that you hear are all trying to get control of the global estate trust, Sister QV trust systems set up by the Jesuit order after the fall of the Red House, that administers over all conquered peoples and their lands. Whose peoples i.e. specifically Moors under the Spanish Inquisition, have been declared dead until proven otherwise. Unum sanctum hegemony, which we talked about before, that's what that is. Unum sanctum hegemony. The unum sanctum hegemony is referred to loosely by some scholars as white supremacy, with limited explanation of what they're really dealing with. For people who cannot read or don't know language or do not know basic etymology science, they'll call it racism and prejudice. Such persons that would use that argument to claim the estate would be declared totally incompetent. And logically, the masses fit that category. This is why I'm saying to you, you got to be able to think multi-level. The keys that the dark priesthood use is substitution, misrepresentation, prima facie presentments, impersonation, personation, distortion, that's safe enough. Though we can go into other levels of fraud, but that's safe enough. Identity theft. All right, so you gotta know how they're thinking and how they're operating all at one time. All right? So when they're communicating with you, they're operating on multi-levels when they're communicating with you. When they send you something in the mail, it's operating on multi-levels. When they're talking to you in any subdivisional agency or municipal operations, subcategory, franchisee, under the corporate states, under the unum sanctum policy, the ones who are in the lower clerk areas are given instructions on operating roughly on three levels. As you go up there, operating on more levels. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Yes.
All right. My point of approach is this. Knowing that most people don't have the power to fight the dark side, is to share with them how they think, if you get the point. And then depend on you to be honest with yourself and just go into your memory and then come out with your energy. Because you have to be, it has to come from you. Do you understand? From my position, the more I can get people agitated enough to think, just to think, and think in that directive, that's how I put the nails in his coffin. You understand? At least my part. There's others, but that's what my mother sent me here for. I could just better carry what she sent me here for. Right? But, so, whenever they're doing things, I always look at what they're doing, and I go behind it. I see what they're doing before they even, you know, so I can project. I can project on them. So, we talked years ago, and remember I told you that the Manchurian Masons were going to put out them assassins?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, they've been doing that, which you already know. That's part of this other stuff that's going on. That's why you see Trump talking trash. That's the dog and pony show. You don't take any of it serious, though you take it serious on other ends. But that's for keep you distracted. No difference in my boxing. If you don't like this, getting ready to catch you with the right. Trump is not crazy. He's not out to lunch, so don't think he is. United States Service Corporation went bankrupt September 30th. So that thing in Los Angeles was a red flag, I mean in Vegas, so don't even think that anything else. They're trying to get the guns from the middle class Europeans who they know, already know this history, who will come after them and ain't gonna sit around and march and pray and talk about, you know, we are somebody type of stuff. So they're, you know, it's sort of like the middle class Europeans know they're being thrown under the bus and they ain't having it. You understand? And so Although I know that you've heard different things that they're doing with different sovereignty groups, you're going to see more. And you're going to see them cracking down. Are we clear? It's Jaham 15. And they've been sending these military operations across this country for the last 10 years. You understand? So they've got tanks and sonic weapons and vehicles, unmarked cars, etc. And anywhere these people are marching or gathering, you know, Black Lives Matter and stuff, which is fraud, George Soros, that's the that really belongs to. They've been hitting them with sonic weapons and stuff like that to get them later. You know? So if there's a crowd marching and praying, go the other direction, go to the movies. Not the big movies, the little movies. You understand? Just a reminder. Don't get caught up in that emotionalism. Because they plan to reduce the population, but they're using other weaponry that the masses are not aware of. We don't need to get into all of this, tell you that, so you do what you want to do. However, I know, see, this is the deal, and it's the same way the Manchurians are operating right now. You're not going to beat Rome's army. It's not going to happen. They're using new, ancient technology. Do you understand? Whatever you think that you got that's up to date is thousands of years old already, including your computers. So don't get it through your mind that that's new technology. It is not. So I'm only telling you that so that you don't get caught up in thinking that you're going to outthink them that way, or that you're going to protect yourself with any hot fire. My appeal is to your inner mind. That's where you want to be. But it has to be sincere. Cannot be cluttered with mean thoughts or evil thoughts. Even though you're being injured. And it must be sincere. Write sincerity down and think about it all the time. The word sincerity. With that said, now I'm going to break down some things. There are other layers, but I want to stay into the key parts of some of the layers of their operation. And so try to stay focused on what I'm telling you, although there's supportive subsection information to explain to you why in 206 I did that article on the dangers of the UCC, because many people have been selling UCC packages to people and processes. And this is how Rome operates. If you contract with him, their position is that you've contracted them and they're superior because they presented to you the format of the contract and you've accepted it. However, to not agree with him, you have not to contract with him. So how do you contract him without contracting with him? Seems like a contradiction, but this is the point. And that's why I wrote that article, Dangers of the UCCs. Not that the UCCs are not in operation. I always saw it as them buying time. They will never honor. They'll honor a few, they'll let a few get so far to keep the followers in faith, which buys them time. Point. Anything that's true to law, true to process, is transparent. If it's not transparent, it's false. It's colored. It's deceptive. Are we clear? So let's just keep this in mind. In 1861, when the Congress of Germany signed a deal, political scientists know it was a coup d'etat. The masses are trained that it was seen a deal. Anybody who knows contract law and corporate operative law and constructive organized government know that seen a deal means without a day. Without a day, that means a There is no return. Therefore, they dissolve their political platform, i.e. the United States does not exist except in name only. Only by virtue of them continuing to operate it with an empty engine, in a sense. Do you understand? In other words, it's a shell. Are we clear?
Clear.
However, with the implied power of that shell, they've been using any amassed energy that they get from the people to turn into war machines to thereby use that energy to attack back at the people who are actually funding the attack against them. Are we clear? This is the perfection of the operations of the Act of Congress, February 2nd, 1871. And you all know, who know basic politics, the fundamental plan of operations since then has been to promote the bankrupted United States Service Company that Lincoln bankrupted in 1860 as a country and convince the people that it is the country, when it actually is a private corporation under unum sanctum hegemony occupying Morocco, Al-Malak, America. So it's important for them, from their position, to pretend to be Americans and to promote that so that it takes root. Are we clear?
Yeah.
It's important for the Dutch masters to promote that the true Americans are Negro, Black, Color, and other brand systems, to remove them from heirship. Is that not complex? It's not complex, is it? Then with the political platform of the United States de facto platform of the kingship oligarchy set in operation February 2nd, 1871, to convert the debt that really belongs to the United States Service Corporation that Lincoln bankrupted in 1860 on the heirs of the estate with whom they have treaty but must breach in order to do this dirt. So to breach the Treaty of Peace and Friendship and its multiple layers, they must breach the Constitution for the United States. Are we clear?
Clear.
So here comes the impersonation. And this is the fundamental political function of the brand system and why the Europeans put their family names on the descendants of the Moors, as well as branding them Negro, Black, and Color to remove them from the obligations of the treaties and to steal their estate, because now they become wards of the state automatically. We're talking default in trust law. Think trust and estate law. Two things we're dealing with, trust and estate law, then contract law. All right? Trust and estate law, then contract law. So as I'm saying different things, just keep that in your mind so that you can have an overall picture in your mind, so that you've got to think on levels. Because some of the stuff I'm not going to be able to go over, so I want you to take notes and I want you to be thinking. So that's why I try to prepare you how I'm thinking, because I know that I can't give this to you in one lecture. So I need you to be sharp. Do you understand? I need you to be sharp. I need you really to be focused, because I'm very serious about this right now. All right? All of the politics that you see, all legislation that comes through the Board of Directors for the United States Service Corporation are designed to fulfill unum sanctum policy, which is really the guidebook of operations at North America and in Canada and in England and in Australia particularly. But the North Gate is where their spear operations come from, because that's the heartland of the Moroccan Empire that they divided amongst themselves during the Berlin Conference 1884, Berlin, Germany, then 1885. Then they introduced the secret treaty of Verona into the record of the Congress, 1916. They set up the platform for the Jesuit P2 Masons called the Federal Reserve and the Inquisition Revenue Services, 1913, 1916, Jekyll Island, which is really the Inquisition Revenue Services, which they call the Internal Revenue Services. So these are all tools for the Jesuit order and Opus Dei for the enforcement of unum sanctum hegemony. Now, you must be cognizant of the fact that anybody in political operations must be aware of this to operate. Are we clear? Therefore, anybody that's in any power position matters not whether it's political or dogmatic, what people think is religion, must be a Mason, or an Eastern Star, Knights Templar, Knights Columbus, etc., Thule Society, Kyklos, Ku Klux Klan, Union Guard, White Chameleon. It's all masonry on different levels, different orders, still masonry. Because they're all clear. I'm just giving you, I'm painting a picture so that you can look at these people and never think that they don't know this just because they're not going to have this conversation. Because they got death oaths. You understand? And the others who don't got a 501c3 skull and bones agreement, kickback payoff, saying that it's for Jesus because they're teaching the word of the Lord. It's the Lord Governors of London. Write that down. The Lord Governors of London. So when these people are saying that they ain't paying taxes because they're doing the word of the Lord, they are. They're not lying. It's just that it's Lord Governors of London. Specifically Westminster District. You know, and this is where you see Article 3 in the Secret Treaty of Verona, the old clergy to the Pope, that we show once in a while. I don't want to go into that right now because we've gone over this and over this. I'm just laying some reference points so everybody can understand what I'm talking about here. Because this is what I want to deal with. All right? And I want you to understand this, how they gentrify our communities and how they foreclose. But my major argument for you, and what I want you to comprehend, is that you have a right of claim argument. And I know for some of you, it will take some time to work these things out. But if you stay focused where I'm sending you, you will have enough power to stop foreclosures, which is why I'm talking to you. Do you understand? Because, see, this is my thing. You don't have the power to stop the corruption. You do have the power to throw a wrench in the gears, which is what we're dealing with. You don't have the power to overcome the dark priesthood that's operating on multi-levels knowing that you're not. So you can't beat them that way. Then they got the military complex to back them up here, even in other nation states, which is what they've been doing. Are we clear? So little armies don't even have power over them. However, this does. Thought does, but the thought must be pure. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, let's talk mortgages, which is a dead pledge. The contract is dead, you're the pledge. Your body and your labor and all future inheritances are the pledge. That's what mortgage means. So people sign these instruments thinking they're getting a loan. All right, so let's explain how this stuff works. And deal with the Romans or the subdivisional agencies. Understand that all corporate operatives who own any corporations in the Western Hemisphere are members of the Roman Curia. Write that down, keep this in mind, that's a reference in your mind. They're all members of the Roman Curia. Are we clear? So understand, if you ever think that they're not operating on a prerequisite of thought patterns, you're mistaken. Are we clear? No matter what organization they belong to, whether it's Sears, Macy's, Mickey D's, Wendy's, ticket department, Roman soldier on the street pretending to be a lawman, all of them are operating under Unum Sanctum operations. Consciously, don't you ever think they're not. All right? Look at anybody, look at them cars, they say Fraternal Order of Police, you see our star upside down. And then you see a tier castle, which is 3 degrees masonry, in the middle. Then you see the eye of Allah. Then you see the grip. And if you think they don't know, that's on you. They know. And they know exactly what they're doing. All right? So let's not go there about thinking that these people don't know. You're the only ones that haven't known. You've been the target, you've been the food. My issue is to make the food start tasting nasty. To reduce the pleasantry of their palates. Vampires don't like salty blood with garlic in it. And this is basically what I'm dealing with. All right? Now, I want you to write these things down. I'm going to mention them at some time in the conversation, but I'm not going to do a lot of discussion on, because we don't have a lot of time, but I want you, because I want you to go home and think about these around 1:30 to 2 o'clock in your mind. Then go into your law dictionaries where necessary, but just contemplate on what I'm telling you. I'll hit on some of these things, some I'll go deeper in, some I won't. But it'll start dawning on you, all right? When people sign mortgages, there'll be two roughly fundamental instrumentalities that they're actually engaging in. I'll name the three, but they'll lock two of them together. It is the mortgage itself and what is called promissory note. All right? And I'll have people sitting there, and they'll sit there and they'll turn the pages, sign here, sign here, sign here. It's a linear contract. If you notice that they don't sign, they just get you.
Right.
All right. It's linear. Now, listen. So on the front, that's unconscionable, all right? I won't go deal with that no more. I'm just laying the layers. What occurs is, in law, the promissory note is your promise to pay the servicer or whoever's giving you substance the return of that substance. Substance for substance. You've been promised dollars or whatever it is. You're going to get a house and, of course, $250, and you wait for them to give you $250. That thing. All right? The promissory note deals with that. Are we clear?
Yeah.
All right. Now, come on quickly because we're in the midst. Is there any more coming in? Now, write down what I'm telling you so that you don't forget. Now we're going to talk law, fundamental law of notes, promissory notes, etc. And I want you to keep this in mind, keep this locked in your mind. In long process of financial instruments, a note has a maximum maturity life of 9 months. Has a maximum maturity life of 9 months. If that note is held by the servicing company or persons that you're communicating with, right? If it's held by them over 9 months, it stops being a note. It goes into another total category in negotiable instruments. It becomes a security 1 minute after 9 months. And it is regulated at that time under Article 3 of their operative uniform commercial codes as a security. Are we clear?
Yeah.
Are we clear?
Yeah.
Now you ask, since it's a security now it goes into another category of operations, now it comes under contract law. All clear?
Clear.
Now, remember when I presented this to you, I'm telling you, some of the things that I presented when we first started talking is for purpose for you to look at this later. When they're dealing with you, they're aware of this while in present tense, right? Now, if you will notice that when people do this, mortgage thing, after they've signed, and that would be called memorialized. They memorialize this instrument, right? Then you hand it to them who represent the loan company or the bank. Are we clear? At that point, you are indebted to them on promise of indebtedness. So it's called a promissory note. You ain't got nothing yet, but you promise it, you give me $5, I'll pay it back. Good point.
Right.
All right. Now they take that promissory note with your memorialization and in violation of the laws that govern notes, they separate it from the mortgage and bundle it in what they call packages or derivatives. Which is already a violation of the operative agreement. Then they take the acceptance of your memorialization, autograph, signature, and monetize it against your Sister Hugh V. Trust estate that the Popes set up after the fall of Alhambra, which all of this stuff is tied to, not knowing that they just declared your body dead. Now they will sign themselves as your trustee over this dead man's estate. And if you got any of the brands, Negro, Black, and Colored, you have no comeback whatsoever. Because only the living heirs of any estate can speak up on behalf of any inheritances or obligations of treaties and constitutions. If you're not a party, you can't use it. This is where the brand system has its legal function. Are we clear?
Clear.
Keep in mind, 1 minute after 9 months, the note matures. They're supposed to deliver it back to you. because it is used to regulate all finances involving this agreement, because the whole operation is predicated on that note. Are we clear? Now, can they give you your note back if they bundled it and sent that to some pooling service corporation that bundles it and puts it on the stock market? That's your note. Now, meanwhile, at the beginning, did they give you that 250 grand? Did they? They have set up with these pooling services on Europe and the Barristers Association, of which all lawyers and attorneys are members. Their obligation is to the court, not to you. We'll leave, right? So they've taken the instrument that you've given them and memorialized it, and now have made it a security, and it hasn't even matured the 9 months. Totally changed the category. At that time, they made you a third party unknown contractee to an unknown contract that they didn't inform you about, to the service pooling company that has that instrument floating around the world with other signatures, but you're obligated to pay the interest. That's what the payments that you think you're making are, but they will list them as deduments because that's all they are, as a gift. Why? Because it was settled when you put your signature on it, because the interest of the energy comes from the Global Estate Trust that the Popes set up in 1492 when the Red House fell. Because they are doing what? What is the Spanish Inquisition? The Inquisition against the Moors. Do most of the heirs of those Moors know who they are? No. They think human beings are crayons. So they're incompetent. So to speak for them, the European put their family names on them. So that makes them automatically fofer or trustee by default. The Emancipation Proclamation of 62 that the Congress modified twice before they killed Lincoln is not a liberation, but is a transference of responsibility. Therefore, they needed a platform for this to operate on to appear legitimate, thus the 14th Amendment. So that they would not, for someone who could see through it, be charged with human trafficking, they needed the people to be not only in their names, in European names, and in brands, they also needed them to be outside the human family. So they applied the scientific name of caveman and monkey to them, Negro Yaber Alibo. So the 14th Amendment made Negroes citizens. They needed them to agree to be Negroes, which means monkey. But they needed somebody they trusted. So, who's the best overseer for the colonists? Rebs and pastors. There you go, Article 3 of your Secret Treaty of Verona. And the promotion of the fakery of separation of church and state, when the state is a franchise of the Vatican. Roman Curia. Are we clear?
Clear.
All right. Clear. Now, they have not delivered to you 250 grand for the house. but instead have transferred a promise to investors that they have already set up, who will fund them after they deliver to the pooling service these bundles of mortgages, dead pledges, dead bodies. Are we clear? All of this is done under commercial operations because you're dealing with human trafficking. Commerce means trade. Are we clear? I.e., forced servitude has been institutionalized. I'll just explain to you how it's done. Are we clear? Anything they buy or sell with the mark or the number of his name, all outcomes belong to the beast of Rome. Same murderers of all prophets that came before you. Are we clear? You don't have to worry about that immediately because we're not going to get to that. We're talking current, but you must know the past to really, really comprehend what you're dealing with now. They're operating on past and present with projection to future. It's called birthright theft. All right? So, to divert you, this is why they give the subtitles racism and prejudice, and they pay people that look like you to walk around you and promote it, and it appears legitimate, but it makes you incompetent because it's not what's going on and never was. Race is the human species. Human species is divided into expanded families that are called nations and nationalities all over Earth planet. Outside that venue, you have no protections under international law. Does that sound complex? I don't think it does. This is why it's necessary for the brand system to be protected and to be promoted. Are we clear? As an example, so if you have a scholar who's a part of that network, a beneficiary, 501c3 recipient, etc., they would take the same information that I'm saying, counter it, try to minimize it, and try to push the black thing on people like it's legitimate, saying we don't know what we're talking about. By political necessity, not because they don't know better. Are we clear? You understand? All right. Because we're talking about movements in and out of the Sister QB Trust set up by the Pope. It's how the world runs. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Clear.
Yes.
So, to reinforce their power over the estates and the unborn, the popes of Rome set up the marriage, Mars, ninth letter to the alphabet, I, and rage, spell cast, to claim the eggs in the fallopian tubes via bank certificate. So marriage certificates are bank bonds. They own the eggs. Are we clear?
Clear.
And it's a bottomry instrument. So they need people to believe it's divine, of the Lord of Jesusness, of Allah, and stuff like that. It's bank bond. And it's part of the mechanism for estate transfer of the unborn, even before they're born. So therefore, they're born in sin. Mm. That's where that really comes from. Telling you the truth. Don't accept anything I'm saying. Examine your mind and prove me wrong. And in doing so, you will learn some things I'm not saying right now. But it will be armor for you. And Mother Nature will protect you if you're sincere. So don't worry about wrong, you just be true.
Now, keep this in mind, from estate law to contract law. Closing. So they got you to sign this dead pledge. They've never delivered anything to you. Unbeknownst to you, they pulled your memorialized instrument into DDC in New York, 55 Water Street, and it's on the stock market. They separated from the mortgage, which automatically makes any claim they make void in law. I'm giving you different arguments, different adverse claims in any foreclosure. And if you fail to bring these things up, you abandon your estate, because we're talking estate law. Although you're in a contract venue over here that they didn't tell you about. So you're layered already, and you need to know that that's what's happening. You need to be aware of it. So I'm telling you why most people lose. That's why I need you to look at all of this like this. Do you understand? All right. Remember, the note matures at 9 months between the introduction of the alleged loan and that 9th month. That note was supposed to be returned to you if you didn't get the $250. In your hand. All right? Meanwhile, what they did is they bundled your instruments, sent it to the pooling service company, then the investors forwarded them the finances. So you financed the loan that you thought they'd given you. Because it's no longer a note, remember, it's now a security, which is a violation of federal law. Now, remember when I did that class on securitization and securities? All right, anybody, just go back to that video and kind of put all of this together. Because all together, it'll make a workshop. Talk to her, she'll take you all the sandwiches. Are we clear? Now, I'm taking my time because I really want you to absorb this. I don't want to get past you, but I also don't want to keep going over stuff. Because I need for you to be effective. All right? So now, not yet. Say, go write it down. So now they have generated finance against your note that is no longer a note, it is now a security. So it allows them to take the security and put it on their ledgers as an asset. So now they're double bookkeeping. But yet they wrote you on the same book as the debtor when you're now the creditor because it became a security. Because they wouldn't have been able to get the finance from the investors if you hadn't memorialized it. And they ain't gave you nothing yet. So now they're in breach. They're supposed to give the note back. They can't because they then pulled it. Are we clear?
Clear.
All right. Within the deed of trust that's veiled in the paper, so have you flip them, sign here. You got a nice handwriting. Oh, man. Ooh, that shit is tight. Sign here. Get my house on something. Unbeknownst to you, the so-called payments that you're giving them, they're going to transfer those payments to the servicing company after they get their cut. Their cut will be called on the paper deed onus. The donors, which means gift. You think you're paying and you just give them a gift. Because it was sealed when you signed it. Remember the global estate trust that nobody's telling you about? What's up, Jim? Again, backing up again, closing. a closing and thinking that they're sealing the deal, right? No, the deal was sealed when you sealed the papers. Closing is getting you to agree to a renegotiation of the loan where they can legally make you a third-party contractor to the pooling services without telling you. Closing is really a renegotiation of the loan. It was closed when you sealed it the first time. Translation, it was paid for. Then they wrote you in books as a debtor. The United States Service Company is a company, not a country. Country is Morocco, under occupation, and all assets belong to the Moroccan Empire, which is overthrown, and to its heirs who have been branded and don't know their heirs, which is the foundation of all contemporary politics on Earth planet. Unum Sanctum Hegemony and the birthright tax. Are we clear?
How do you spell that?
Unum Sanctum Hegemony. Y'all got this because we're racist.
Yep.
Part of this. See that stuff? Write it down, please. If you ain't, just take your camera and take a picture of whatever you're going to do. Because these are reference points, all right? I used to be over here fighting. Get this stuff up when you tell me about the film. My holy son, we was working with that thing.
Plastic.
Now keep in mind, for control purposes and for people who can't read or don't know real history, this will be called white supremacy. But then, if you're trying to operate to fix it, you would be incompetent because you don't know what you're dealing with. Do you understand? Because if you're talking racism and white supremacy, you're dealing with connotation distinguished from denotation. So you can't present the argument. Someone else will have to represent you on the argument, and they're not going to operate in your interest because they're members of the bar. They're deputy knights of the pool. That's why people keep losing. You get the point? Generation after generation, they're not lacking intelligence, they don't know what they're dealing with. And people who know ain't talking. Are we clear?
Clear.
And some others who know are getting paid off, whether cushy job or just their 501c3 skull and bones agreement that Lyndon Baines Johnson set up for their marching Negro leader guys. All right? Their job is to promote the 14th Amendment under the Civil Rights Act. Sound legitimate slave clause. is the dead misrepresenting the living so they can convert the life of the living to the dead, then take the corpse and drain it. That's how the vampires work. I'm clear. Just as a memory to you, when they closed the Bureau of Refugees, Freedmen, and Abandoned Lands in 1868, they loosely referred to it as the Freedmen's Bureau. The reason why the heirs didn't get the 40 acres and the mule and all substantive supports for building homes and economic support is because they were the plan of the conversion. All right? And so this is why they gave the Roman Curia subdivisions the designation of person so that they convert the estate to the corporate person, and then them being the administrators over it, they could extract the substance and build bonds on it, etc., while the heirs are impoverished, who don't know the heirs. That's called 14th Amendment person, or the man of straw that they've been operating on, to convert the debt that off the United States Service Corporation that Benjamin Franklin had registered in France in 1754, that Lincoln ran on and bankrupted when he recognized that they were using him to overthrow the Republic, and he bankrupted it. Their revenge was to convert the debt on the descendants of the Moors, which is where all your mistreatment has its root. And the brand system has its root. And purpose and function. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Yeah.
So you're not talking racism, you're not talking prejudice, you're talking birthright theft. If you don't understand that, you will never win in any estate argument. Which is why we keep losing. Are we clear? Keep in mind, your marching prayer and leader, guys, for 33-degree Green Masons, know this. And they play dumb. Like they don't know that's a Moorish fez. They even have parades all over the place. Even the Mummers parade right there in Philly. Every year, celebrate the fall of the Moors, right in their face. They even assemble at 6th Moor Street. Yeah, that's what it is, my book. So keep this in mind. That's what they're operating on. So they give the masses race and prejudice arguments so they don't pay attention to what's really going on. Because it keeps them busy. Keeps them out of the hair of the rulers. The point? Huh? All right, now. So, a closing is a renegotiation of the loan that you thought you just made, as if that never took place. And they make you thinking that you're sealing the deal of that loan that you initiated. Meanwhile, they ain't gave you nothing yet. But they did do some paperwork to their boy, who has the other company, to hold the instrument. And then usually, after the 72 hours, they usually already contact another corporate representation, mortgage company or holder, and they sell the mortgage again. And then you get the mail, they got a new mortgage holder, Fred Fosnazzo, Dinkle, and stuff. And they're still acting as the in-between, and everybody gets a piece of the action, right? Then, they may do it again, but usually they do it once, at least once. Sometimes they'll do it again, according to what deals they're doing. Keep this in mind. All banking operations start at about 1 o'clock in the morning to about 5. Through the day, they just messing with you. Their real work, midnight, 5. That's what we talked about. Zeroing their books. and converting their debt to you. Are we clear? Now, when they start sending people those 192s, those 192s is when you skip a couple of gifts that you think is payments. They say, oh, you didn't send us our golfing finance this week. We're going threatening to sell. We do the trust. Right? That's that 192. Right? So you're getting ready to be in foreclosure. You better catch up and everything. You know we have a right to call a loan. How do we have a right to call a loan? The whole thing is why most people lose, right? It's called a quote unquote confessed judgment. Write that down. Confessed judgment. That's in the deed of trust. And you were supposed to be informed of it, but they always mark that out. Keep this in mind. Whenever there's a foreclosure, the action of any plaintiff or claimant, FOFR, trustee, that I was regulating any said mortgage or packages of mortgage, being a trustee, supposed to inform you that you have automatically, when they do their action, the right to introduce a defense called an adverse claim. Not how many payments you made and all that kind of stuff. It would be in your interest to have already had that adverse claim up and running. Because now you're in danger of what they call latches. Write that down. Latches would mean you wait around too long, then they don't allow you to make your claim. So therefore, whenever there's a foreclosure action, you have a mandatory right of claim of an adverse claim, and then you also have a permissory claim, meaning they can permit it if you make a good argument. However, it ain't already running, you're already in trouble. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? So in the deed of trust, you sign something else to yourself, an agreement for confessed judgment. So essentially from the beginning, you made a judgment against your own right of estate to them anyway. So at any time they could sell it if they wanted to anyway. All clear? Now, hold on. Now we're going to get into contract law. Contract law. They didn't give you your note back after 9 months, and since they kept it, it became a security. It is no longer a promissory note. You're in a whole different, you're from the stream, you know, the little pool behind the house. You're in Atlantic now. They ain't told you that. You just jumped off the board and stuff. Let me flip a little bit. Sharks don't look sardines. And truthfully, that's how they would get me. Now, this operates on more than mortgages. It operates in all economic transactions dealing with them under commercial codes. When we tell people to carefully study House Joint Resolution 192, the reason why we tell you to study it is because Trump is letting a lot of keys out. But you all also know why they murdered him a couple years ago. When you do the proclamation papers and stuff that we be giving people and we tell them, please study. I want to back up some and put you in, because multiple levels. This is a reminder. This is only for some of you who haven't been here. Some of you know, some of you have been here. Because you got to put this in context. You got to look at this multi-level. Lincoln bankrupted the United States Service Corporation in 1860. 1861, Congress of General Sina Diaz, which was really a coup d'etat. They set up a shell corporation to cover up this whole scenario and to have, pardon me, a political platform by which they could convert the estates of the descendants of the Moors under the Christian Black Codes to refill their coffers. Are we clear? This is 1861. They needed to perfect that platform. So within a 10-year period until February the 2nd of 1871, that's the Act of Congress, 1871, write that down, for those who don't already know this. So they set up another corporate shell in Guam and in Puerto Rico. That one lived until 1913. No withdrawal except the old Canaanite temple commanded the Queen of England to honor her obligations to the Constitution and to the treaties and to stop hitting our people with the brand systems to steal their birthright. He's speaking up. The masses don't even know what the hell he's talking about, but they kind of feel he's a good guy. So a lot of people start following him, but they don't really. He's talking about this lost estate, and but they really only, most of them don't know what he's talking about. All right, meanwhile, Marcus Garvey is teaching government instruction. Are we clear? Trying to qualify these heirs who don't know the heirs. Meanwhile, Rome infiltrates both organizations to neutralize them. Are we clear? Duvalier sets up Old Canaanite Temple for the restoration of the estate. That crashes at the United States, so now Woodrow Wilson is forced to meet with the Jesuits, Opus Dei, Lords of London bankers off Jekyll Island, Georgia, to sell the residuals of the shell that just now crashed again, 1913. There you go, Federal Reserve. Order of the Jesuits. Are we clear? Then the Internal Revenue Services is really the Inquisition Revenue Services to continue the unum sanctum tithe tax under occupation. Morocco is under occupation. Are we clear? Meanwhile, the heirs are being taught. And some of them get it, some don't. He sets up an order and assigns people who are supposed to fulfill the job of carrying this information to the people. Can't talk now.
Can't stop now.
Stop. Anyway. So. That. Corporate shell, you gotta keep this in mind, these shells. Corporate shell called the United States Service Corporation, they just spell it differently, but it's still the United States. Now remember, since 1861, through their political platform, all Masons, Eastern Stars, except Daughters of American Revolution, Kai Klos, Union Guard, White Camellia, Ku Klux Klan, Shriners, are to promote the corporation as if it's the country. Since 1861. Reaffirmed 1871. The calculation is a few generations should be all it takes where the people don't know basic geography. So as soon as you say the United States, they think it's North America land. So they give up their estate thinking that that's they're the authoritative government when actually they're a secret board of directors for the Lords of London, governors for the United States Service Corporation that was bankrupted by Lincoln in 60. Are we clear? So that false identity is well in place. The German Dutch masters had already introduced the brands Negro, Black, and Colored, so the descendants of the Moors can't claim the estate because they think human beings are crayons. They're totally incompetent. Then when they sign names, they sign Smith, Jones, and Johnson. They're European property. Dred Scott principle? Amistad principle? It ain't changed. William Dunkey case? All right. That is the setup for what you're dealing today with mortgage and gentrification across this country. Are you clear? Dead pledge. Your body's the pledge, your labor's the pledge, all inheritances are pledged. Point in history, though we won't go into it, just a reminder. Corporate, state of Delaware, referred to being the first in the agreement with the 13 colony operations at Morocco, at the North Gate.
That's a lie.
It is not true. Representatives did not sign the Constitution. So they lied. All right? Neither did Rhode Island. George Washington sent an army up there and forced them to sign. That's why if you start reading the records, you'll see that disparity if you can count and pay attention. I'm just throwing that in because all scholars know this. All politicians know this. All Masons know this. When you say Masons, we talk about all of the Knights Templars, Eastern Star, George Washington Revolution, the whole club. All of them study Isis and Horus, i.e. Mary and Jesus, i.e. your mother and the son study of earth culture. All right? So they gotta all know in order that they don't start believing their own BS. That's why anybody that's in power must be a Mason. That's loosely phrased, but that means you gotta have a real knowledge of the real operations on earth as opposed to the belief systems that are given to the masses, which is mind control. Are we clear? Specifically, it's called dogmata. Dogma, dogmata. So to protect the power elite, all priests, reverends, imams, teachers, professors, all of them are PhDs and all of them are Gnostics. Are we clear? To keep the masses from figuring out that they're being played, they're getting strong belief systems. Put a bunch of different flavors. I like vanilla. All right, you got that? Nice, strawberry. These are called denominations and sects. I like pecan. I know the north of London. That's what they pay him. Everybody up with them. Translation, they've been funding their own enslavement. That's how this thing has been working so well. All right. Well, let's get to the point, then we'll get to your questions, and so we'll do some interchanges. When we gave you the proclamation papers, it is essentially an adverse claim, but it's to get you in that thought or the frame of mind, but it's also claiming certain rights that already belong to you that were converted from you under the commercial platform that they set up. Are we clear? Yeah. 1966, representatives of Texas wanted to go on the program. This is where Texas wanted to secede. California, you still had some people that were sympathetic with, because you know that was Khalifa's land out there. That's where you get Khalif from Khalifa. That's when you see that sister over there with the dreadlocks, and that was her territory. From the lower part of Canaan land, which you call Canada, that's Canaan land, down to part of Nevada, all of Khalifa's land, part of Mexico. And Mexico was up to New Mexico and part of Nevada in that area. That's really Mexico, right? They were, even right now, one of the low-level problems that they have that they're worried about, because they knew that Texas and California area that undercurrent they want to secede, even right now. So I'm just throwing that in you so you understand some of the politics that you see and some that you don't see, so you can understand that people in government don't think like you think. People in operative orders, privy council, do not think like you think. What you gotta do is start thinking like they think in order to play chess. Are we clear? All right, which is why I'm staying focused on this. Because they're being pressured on multi-levels, all right? And so they're trying to liquidate everybody's estate as quickly as they can, and they're trying to fund their operations, which just collapsed September 30th. So this, anybody who knows politics know that this gun thing that happened in Las Vegas, the red flag.
Sure.
It's a military operation.
That's right.
So you can get the gun justified, get some quick legislation, colorful legislation to get the guns from the middle class Europeans. They know they ain't gonna let them come take their sandwiches. See, they can stomp our people and all like this and you know, that kind of stuff. We march and pray. Middle class Europeans don't do that kind of stuff. He will get his rod, his staff, and comfort somebody. He will. And they know that. Because they know the Europeans know the real history. The only ones that don't know the real history is people that think human beings are crayons.
Yeah.
And they're kind of waking up now, so it's just getting a little bit uncomfortable. They don't exactly know. They know something's up. They ain't exactly got their thing together, but they're on the way. Which means that the derivative system is going to collapse. Then you have the Manchurian Masons who put out those 6.5 million assassins a few years ago that have been neutralizing them. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? 60% of all commercial buildings in Manhattan now belongs to China. You say China, it's China. Tian Yi. All right, all your new buildings that you see taking place around the country that's being erected is backed by Chinese gold.
That's right.
All right? All your major ports, Boston, Long Beach, Los Angeles, biggest ports in North America, China. Are we clear?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, the heirs here don't recognize themselves as Asiatics when they're being aided. Meanwhile, Rome's gonna try to starve you out. But they also have to, they're in a catch-22 because they got to also keep you having faith in the system. Blind faith in the system. Not faith, blind faith in the system. Meanwhile, they're pressured by Manchurian Masons. And some P2 Masons that are with Francis to try to fix this thing so that some of them don't get bumped off. And then you got others who are resisting. So you got civil war going on. Meanwhile, anyone who's in control of anything are trying to accelerate any calls of loans to satisfy their debts, even though it can't be satisfied. Go ahead. Okay, speak up loud too.
How or why is it being funded by China? And what was the how was the spelling of it?
We'll get into that later. You need to understand history to understand that. United States corporations have been operating on Chinese gold for the last 50 years. Got no real politics. Go ahead.
Someone else was asking for that pronunciation again that you gave for China. Is it China?
China.
China.
C-H-U-K.
Okay.
And also Tang Dian. You saw, yeah. Tian Yi.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's real, C-H is really a K. But we say China proper, China, or Manchuria, too. And a lot of the gold that's been operating on the planet in these late years is actually old Manchurian family gold. So get it out of your ideas and your heads that the United States is a country. It's a corporation that has been through military operations under Unu Sanctum, going to and fro the earth, devouring nations and stealing their resources.
Wow.
Are we clear? With the help of the heirs to the world's largest estate, who thought they were U.S. citizens, and calling themselves Negroes and Blacks. And Rome has never won a war without them. Although they're the target of the lost estate, we don't know. That's the foundation of all contemporary politics on planet Earth. This is why Hitler told Churchill, so you get them stovepipes out of the war, we'll kick your asses. Them stovepipes, he's talking about the Moors, so, who think they black. Think they black. Who are cannon fodder for their own enslavement. Dumbass. It's true. That's another subject matter in itself. Great,
so it's the same Orion group that's controlling.
Speak up loud.
Here.
That's the mic behind.
It's on.
Is the same Orion group that's controlling the US also controlling China then?
You can say that. Except for a few, Rome has pretty much been in control of most of the nation states. And I think, do the research, because I don't like to project things if I'm not correct. Some parts of Manchuria, Korea, and Iran, probably the only nation states that don't have Knights of Malta operations, which is why they bombed Syria to the point, which is why they bombed them, which is what this all is in North Korea. This is what this, all this dog and pony show is about. Because it represents an axis of, if they don't overcome this, they fall. It's time. Because they've been able to shell up again. So let's look at this. Marcus Garvey, teaching the Starfleet government, Nobles Raleigh had already crashed one. Remember, Lincoln crashed one. Nobles Raleigh crashed one in 1913. That lived. They re-registered in Guam, Puerto Rico. 1925, Hoover and them, and I think it was Coolidge, right at that time, started COINTELPRO operations, infiltrating all Asiatic and Aboriginal organizations to neutralize them. Nobles Raleigh registered the Moorish Temple of Science, sometimes referred to as Moorish Holy Temple of Science, as a civic organization to accelerate the teaching of government for the heirs, 1925. That crashed at the United States Corporation again, 1925. They hid it. It still lived. But they re-registered the United States Service Corporation. That's that papers I've been giving you all, the United States Service Corporation 25. Countermeasure. That's why you see the United States Service Corporation re-registered in Florida and in New York, 1925. All right. They set up another one secretly. They was going through a whole bunch of crap. Nobles Raleigh was meeting with all the true American states, Organization of American States, OAS, in Havana, Cuba. And this is where that area where you get the great sellout. All right? With the infiltrators, etc. So now, Raleigh crashed two of them. Lincoln crashed one. They were scrambling. The infiltrated, etc. Raleigh told Calvin Coolidge to put the star back in the flag. All right, so we got the flag, the solid red, and we got the star back in the flag, and they start putting it back in the books. 1928, they start putting our great seal back on the note. 1928, that's your great seal. Of course, the people still sleep, so Illuminati is trying to claim the rights, because they're stealing the birthright. That's why you see Illuminati use your seal. This is why, like in that movie, when they do the National Treasure, they do it in Philadelphia. And then the woman's trying to complete her coin collection. And after all these years and She happened to notice the watermark of the Great Seal in the paper,
right.
And they're running all around between Boston and Philadelphia, and they're looking for these papers, and they find that Philadelphia's on these chambers. And then in the movie, they did two of the movies, and then you see them running to Pennsylvania House, which is later called Independence Hall, where they steal the birthright, Carpenter's Hall, all over there. And he pulls out this brick with fingers like this,
right.
Four corners,
right.
That's your four corners, right. Masonry, and you get the shades with the foot, ether, blue ether,
right.
You understand? And then they find the treasures of Egypt, it's right under Philadelphia, and they light it up, and you can't even see the end of it.
Right.
Because you're standing on Egypt. They're just telling you the truth, you know. See, this way the dark priesthood can remove some of the karmic debt off themselves because they told you. They just tell you in a movie. So people think it's fiction. So they're still trying to go someplace else. They're incompetent. And still making an adverse claim on their estate that they're standing on. Now you see the whole Quran, when Jawali says the jewels are beneath your feet. Chapter 47, he's giving you the parameters of your lost estate. Then Rami Emanuel, the Jew, left the Obama administration 2010, December the 22nd, the first full day of the North Gate, winter soul, sun stands still, Jesus in the tomb 3 days. He issued a proclamation to tell what Nobodrale did, told these people that they're the people of the land, North, Central, and South America. And establish theocratic government, in other words, you come back into governmental form. He's a Jew, he's telling his history. So that relieves the karmic debt off the dark priesthood. Somewhat.
Yeah.
Because they're telling you. Now remember, you already been told. You're just being sold out by your black leaders. Now, meanwhile, in the background, they're under pressure of Manchurian assassins. So representatives of the Pope of Rome, they're going out on balconies after lunch. Oh, it's just such a beautiful scene. How did I slip over this rail that's up here? Go flying and stuff like that. Go flying a little bit, going to spend my sex and stuff like that. Hey, got my parachute. They'll admit to about 35 or 40 of them. There's others that are not mentioned. So now they're negotiating in the background. Meanwhile, our people still sleep. So meanwhile, the deputy knights, bankers and others, are being forced to accelerate foreclosures and everything to try to pay off. But they can't pay off, so they're trying to sacrifice here. Anybody that don't have an adverse claim already in order probably won't lose. Already running. Already acting. And you need to know to invoke it. Now, let's get the point. When they're selling the deed of trust under the principle of your confessed judgment already hidden in there, and by them not returning you a note after 9 months, which it matured, by them keeping it, it became a security. So it became an asset for them. So your creditor being misrepresented as the debtor, they ain't never gave you $250, and ain't gave you a note back either. So now you have proprietary interest in that note, don't you?
Yes.
So let's talk. Let's talk. So you're foreclosing. Is that a Taji guy?
All right, man, you made big payments and stuff. I went to the golf course and everything, and I noticed that they didn't sell this shit. So we're gonna sell this shit.
Adverse claim. I think you misrepresented this. So, y'all can stop all these negotiations. I'm going to rescind my signature off that note, and I want my note back right now.
It's long.
Right then, at that point, the foreclosure process stops.
You better be in your proper person, though, when you say that. Because if you black, Smith, Jones, and Johnson, you have no right to state. You can't make the claim. Because the land's Morocco. If you didn't know that, it's called cookies. The heirs are Moors. You want to be black? You're Christian property. You can't even talk. If you're U.S. citizen, you cannot rebut. This is the problem that Europeans are finding themselves in.
That's right.
Who agreed to be white people.
That's right.
In 1854. To a benefit under the hegemony. Now it's backfiring on them. Are you following what I'm saying to you? Your proclamation papers themselves are an adverse claim. However, in the foreclosure process, brakes, all this stuff, air brakes, whatever kind of brakes you got, bicycle brakes, you know. Can't do the slot because you got snakes on. Look cool with you. Stop the works. I am true creditor because they took that note and they never returned my note. And they never gave me that 250. And they made me an unrevealed party to a pooling services company, and they did a lot of derivative stuff. They didn't tell me about all that. And now that you have these foreclosure procedures, when that action was introduced, they didn't notify me that automatically my right of adverse claim comes about as soon as they start making foreclosure arguments. Come even tell me about that. And it's mandatory, Fred. So, since y'all want to play dirty, I want my note back right now because I'm removing my signature. Uh-oh, everything falls apart. You understand? Now, what I want is I want a report, Fofer, trustee, on all finances and monies and signatures that was put on my note that was never returned to me, which was supposed to be returned to me at maturity at 9 months to the 12 o'clock thing. You kept it 1 minute past, and I ain't seen it yet, it became a security. So now we're in contract law. So since the contract was built on my memorialization, I want my coins.
Yes, sir.
Now, it ain't like I'm happy about this, but you can take my interest in this, since you all been doing all the stuff you're doing, and you can offset the alleged debt. You know, I ain't finished with you. You're going back home. Because I just made adverse claim on my estate. You just fired the trustee. That's how you stop the bullying. However, the reason I did that article in 206, and I revised it in 209, is because a right, an heirship, a birthright should not be executed on a commercial platform. Because an unalienable right cannot be bought, sold, or transferred by any governing body. It's called earthy righty. So know what your nationality and birthright is for real and use it. All clear? All right, now we can talk. What y'all want to talk about?
I have a quick question.
Mike, get the mic.
Give her the mic and speak loud.
How you doing? Islam, I wanted to know if a property was sold under or through sheriff's sale, however.
Just what I just told you, an adverse claim, an adverse claim you would do an estoppel or rebuttal, writ of error, etc., claim the fraud. I just identified 5 parts to you. That's why I took my time. I want you to understand so that you can think this over. Those of you
who can't think in layers. Get the DVD from D. I apologize, D, because you don't talk to you like this, but you gotta get to work when you get home. But you gotta make some sandwiches.
Sandwiches!
But, and then take notes, please. There's more that we could discuss in subsections of UCCs, but I don't push UCCs. I push birthright that supersedes UCCs. But UCCs would be for Europeans who are operating under juristic operations. Do you understand? But understand, they breached the Constitution and treaties, so they lost any right of claim. That's why you see a lot of wealthy Europeans taking their finances that they can try to save off the shore, and then they use that Arizona Resolution 2748 to claim all their accounts and stuff. They going after them. You understand? All right. But meanwhile, remember, they've been claiming you to be U.S. citizens to convert the debt, and they've still been doing that. And the so-called leaders of the churches, civic groups, and other organizations who have been told and informed by the international community to distribute this information at all costs. Look at Rights of Indigenous People that Obama signed. It's right there, documented. I don't have to tell you that these people ain't doing nothing like what we're doing right here in the House of Rewritten Minds. So we don't have to argue it. You go to an international record, go to international law, go to Rights of Indigenous People, and see that churches, civic groups, all in all communities across this country were charged to distribute this information at all costs. And I don't have to tell you they ain't been doing it, because you already know they ain't been doing it. I won't have to be thinking twice to try to explain it to you. You see what I'm saying to you? But anyway, this is my whole point for tonight. This is, we've been over this in different manners over and over again. It's just that the timing is so important, and because the dark priesthood is accelerating your activities, and you need to not be asleep, because they're going to suck your body and drop like a couple of dead carcasses. You understand what I'm saying to you? And people who think that they're safe, but they think they're paid up. No, it's never paid up. A discharge and a set off, though not exactly the same, are what's in operation under occupational government. Are we clear?
Yeah.
Because you're not dealing with money. You're dealing with estate law, trust law. Are we clear? And they're taking notes that you have sealed or memorialized and securitized them, and then have used the instruments, marriage certificates, birth certificates. That's what Franklin Delano Roosevelt did. So after Raleigh had crashed that shell, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, that's when he took the birth certificates and monetized them and made them bank bonds. In 1933. That's how it's Joint Resolution 192, 73rd Congress in session, June the 5th of 1933, and the fake bank holiday. And then he starts stealing everybody's gold again. Gold Act and all that kind of stuff, trading with the enemy act, all that kind of stuff. All that is to enforce the unum sanctum hegemony. Not racism, not prejudice. Unum sanctum hegemony. That's the tool for the theft of the state of the Moors. You're under occupation. And what Raleigh says in your lessons, he says, black according to science means death. He's not talking etymological. He's talking according to state law operations and competence of being. When he says, be yourself, it means in propria persona. That means the heir must be named. When you declare your nationality, you are heir unconditional. But you don't have to argue that when you say you're Moorish American. That's it. Because they already know ain't nobody here but Moors and European occupiers who've been pretending to be Americans, and the dumb heirs have been calling them Americans, which makes them incompetent and also transfers the power of the sovereign seat. Then they call him white man, which means sovereign. So the heirs keep empowering him, then they get pissed because he uses the power that they keep assigning him to. It's called connotative linguistics.
Yes, go ahead.
Mike.
She can sing too. That's why she's really actually Mike. Yeah, don't lay if I know you can sing.
Sing.
Don't miss it.
Okay. Claiming my nationality as more.
You can't be as more.
I mean, well, claiming my nationality.
What did we talk about on the way up here?
What, my language.
Connotative linguistics.
Kind of, yeah.
All right. This cannot be as a chair. This is a chair. Being myself.
Being myself.
Oh, continue.
Okay. Being myself. You also mentioned that. We have to, it's to our advantage to already have
be active. Now let's back up. When we say ongoing, you can convert that to what Jolly said. I want active moors, not passive moors. Why? Because the passive air can be dismissed on the principle of laches. Also on the principle of incompetence. Because everything operative in the Western Hemisphere is a global estate trust set up by the Pope of Rome, 1492. And all corporate operations, corporate states, corporate franchises, are members, their heads, CEOs, are members of the Roman Curia. They're operating on this. Guess what happened to you speaking in any other context? You're incompetent. And if you don't know who you are, you certainly ain't going to talk. You want to succeed and say paying stuff. And I have my investment as a colored person of color. You just said I'm an artificial person. Don't we talk about no human rights then? You see how that works together?
Yeah.
This is why we keep telling people. Make sure, this is why we even give them the law books in digital form until they can start investing in themselves. Because what they think things mean is not what they mean.
That's right.
Then you have these marching, praying black leader guys who say, you know, Jesus and Allah and everything, the black man, and you be following after them, they're selling you out.
Yeah.
Once you understand the state law, you would know that they're selling you out. If you don't, you think that they're just an emotional statement of blackness of the Kabbalistic nature of Hotep, of Kemet. No, you just come on Christian Black Codes, your property. So, if you're not in your proper person in the first place, they have jurisdiction. I don't care how beautiful you write anything. However, that is only cleaning up the platform. Now you know, gotta know how to use it. Because if you're incompetent, it's cold. You start mixing that black language in an argument over state and see how quick they put a barrister on you from England. And at that point, you're losing. See, because a free woman, free man, present themselves. A serf or ward will be represented by another man.
That's right.
Because if you start running your mouth, they'll punch you in your mouth and charge you with contempt. You can't do that, and they punch you again.
Ow.
In his cuffs.
You understand?
We're talking real talk. That's exaggeration. But it's very simple. Let's think this way. Keep it very simple. Mothers, children, nations, citizens, nations, nationals. Are we clear?
Yes.
Interrelationship aliens under the Naturalization Act. Sometimes mothers are taking care of them, mothers, children. Then we interchange. Sometimes they're over your house, sometimes they're over your house.
Okay.
In international law, nationhood, think family so you can understand nationality.
Right.
All right, now, mom. Mom's hooked up, and she got the stuff over here.
Yeah.
low, right? Everybody jump over him. Right? Now mom's getting sick. They just go over and text and all this sort of stuff.
Check out the night.
Whatever. Took one of her slippers even. So she's up there. I don't know about this. My children got to eat. Everybody got to go home. See your mom. When I get my stuff back together, y'all cool, you might come back over right now. Kite. Balloons. We'll supply you with some. Ship. Logs. Frog feet. Party's over.
Party over. You ain't got to go home. But you got to go home to your own mom.
You're off the rest. Mom, put your bra back on. That's how it works.
It is the same thing in international law government. When a nation is going down the tube, the superior and most supreme saving power politically is called nationalization.
That's it. That is where
it's on paper. It was some people occupying Germany because Germany could not have a standing army after the Treaty of Versailles. Some of them were German, Polish, and others. But they were claiming a religion as a nationality while controlling their economy. All of which they were none of these things. Claimed to be somebody they're not. So German, so Hitler, nationalized Germany, say. Oh, we got some boats over there, cabs and stuff like that. Party's over. Hit it. Go home to your mom. All right. Still controlled the economy, was going down the tube. So what he did, he invited everybody to barbecue parties.
That's some barbecue. Man, that's a big picnic. Put a supply trains in it. Send cab to your house. Cut it short. They heard up and got a nationality. They even told them why they was out coming through. Yeah, man, hey, man. I need a van before I go to the party and stuff. You understand? I said, hold on for a minute. Bring them flyers over here. Say something again.
I said, man, a van.
What kind of gold tube we saw? Can't follow them over here. That's our shit. They went to England. Did they let them off them ships?
Nope.
They went to Falkland Islands. Did they let them off them ships?
Nope.
They went to Cuba. Did they let them off them ships?
Nope.
So they threatened to tell the real Yahudi or the real Jews who they really are. So they started a war, and they made up an artificial nation in 1948 called Isis, Amun-Ra, Elohim. Two letters from each, Is, Ra, Il. And they took our hex alpha, put it in the blue ethers, turned it blue, and claimed nation state. And according to the book of John, 844, claimed to be somebody they're not. However, they heard about nationality. Now if you read Executive Order 11490, Silent Weapons for Quiet Wars, Technical Manual, Rex 84. The same technology that was used there being applied to some other people currently that claim to be in the minorities, that have no nationality, and they're going to exterminate them, which is why we're talking what we're talking here at the House of Great Working Minds, because they're accelerating. People don't know this suit. So they're using biological warfare, they're using UCCs to trade their estates. They're foreclosing on all properties, they're gentrifying all over the country, and they're accelerating foreclosures on your estate. It ain't just a house, it's more than your house. It's the Sister Cube V trusts that are tied to the global estate trust that they're trying to liquidate. It's more than what you see. It is in your interest to have an ongoing adverse claim, which is why we've been giving people proclamation papers for years, so that it's out there. Because it's already running. Are we clear?
However, same claim can be made in any foreclosure. All clear?
Yeah.
Because I'm specifically doing it at foreclosures because they're stealing people's houses as quickly as they can. And so that's why I'm focusing on this. That's why I told you when I started this, I don't want to go on every little detail. I want to stay focused on certain parts. But I'm giving you your argument. Are we clear?
Yeah.
A multi-level argument, all of which will stop a foreclosure. Tom says.
Bye.
Islam, questions / statement. With the current or the recent weather wars, and I heard you mention about Texas desiring to succeed.
To succeed,
and I did find out that in either 2015 or 2016, Texas had withdrawn about $1 billion in gold bullion from the Federal Reserve.
They built in Texas gold vaults for people around the country to start also depositing their value of bulls at Texas. But there's a dual fort there. There's another Kabbalistic family that has tunnel cities under Houston, which is so you got to kind of look at this two ways. So they held the storm over there over 5 days. Anybody understand weather patterns on Earth planet Gaia? No, she doesn't work that way.
That's right.
All right. And then they had backup if that didn't work. All right. Now, United States Service Corporation registered in Puerto Rico. Now you understand that in the backup storm.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So you got to look at that two ways.
Speech.
And then you got to look at Trump down there. They're throwing them paper towels like basketball. He said, "He's crazy. We gave you all that money. He's crazy. You need to understand what's really going on."
Well, we discussed this a little bit, but with regard to Puerto Rico, I said to you when we were talking the other day that they have no more use for them now that they. And then with regard to Texas, my question is: when you talk about gentrification, the hurricane, I see it as a way to decimate a large mass, and that most of those people are in a position where they will not be able to rebuild and
consider this. Their first major attack on us was through the Caribbean, or for Taino, the last of the Atlantis Islands. You understand? This is another reason why Boricán, because that's not really Puerto Rico, Boricán, why they set their corporation there. This is symbolic for a claim under the Unum Sanctum policy for the Popes of Rome. Do you understand? And the people there are not Puerto Ricans, they're Moors.
That's right.
Do you understand? See, but if they get all the heirs start calling themselves something that they're not, that gives Rome mandate. That's what he's been operating on. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, you still have to look at it two ways. It's two things. They want to wipe out certain evidences because their major paperwork, Puerto Rico is their headquarters. Puerto Rico is the headquarters for the United States Service Corporation,
right,
that's been operating the military complex for the Pope of Rome, pretending to be the country here in northwestern Mexico.
Right.
And it's falling apart. Do you understand? Now, for the brothers and sisters on the island, if they go back to their divine mind, they can stop all that stuff. But they got to give up the dogma that they adopted from Rome. They got to render unto Caesar what is Caesar's. How do I turn the pen? You understand? See, but this is back to point. And it's the same thing that the Manchurians, or China, have already shown the pattern. You're not going to beat the beast's army. However, you must come together and put your energy together. Now you understand how the Quran closes and it says, this is the uniting of Asia. Mm-hmm.
They probably gave you all the keys. It's just you got to understand he was talking on multiple levels. Past, present, and future at the same time. And you've got to think the same way. Are we clear? And you've got to be operative in here and in your heart. Because nature does not recognize person or station or your crazy belief systems. They have nothing to do with harmonics in nature. She doesn't recognize anything. She only recognizes merit. This is why the dark priesthood promote belief systems. That's his power. Because they think it means God, Jesus, Allah, Moses, and Muhammad. No, it's a tool of the dark priesthood. They're vampires. Like, really, really, really? Their job is to keep the sheeple busy while they get raped by the elite, who they are a party to. There is no separation of church and state, because the state belongs to the church. This is why the Pope of Rome was forced to tell the people that the United States is not a country. It's a corporation. It's the hidden Vatican Crown Empire. Is that not documented? It is.
Yeah.
And what do these people keep saying? The positive participle, the government, my mother. That's what you're saying, you see? The my. They don't know what you're talking about. Go ahead.
Okay, so in that document that the Pope issued, his lawyer issued to Obama, they were referring to U.S. Minor, that was the corporation.
That's exactly correct. It's the different ones. Let me just interject that so that you, let's just, for sake of people. Now, and this is, and remember this, this is one of the things that anybody that is what they call, well, even that must be taken with a grain of salt, or Satanist, or Luciferian, because you got dark side and light side in all the orders, meaning that you got the Illuminati of the light and you got the Illuminati of the dark. Are we clear? We're talking about the real politics. All right. See, so don't you see that apostolic letter? Also that one too, which is on your flash drive that I give you all anyway. But particularly if we want to go to the Pope's letter to Obama. And what we want to do is, all right, this is a synopsis. You already know the coup d'etat 1871. And, all right, let's go down. Now, see this issue to all members of domestic police forces? Keep in mind, this is a knowledge that all of these are really deputy knights for the Inquisition operations. So where the common people think that they're really law enforcement, they're actually Roman soldiers. Members of what is known as the Gangs of New York that assembled in Harlem with commissionary work under the Un Sanctum policy to pretend to be law enforcers by uniforms that would be funded by the Roman Curia operators, corporations, and spread out in different fraternal orders and raise hell on all the Aboriginal people of the land and call themselves policemen. All right, so he's issuing, these are technically mercenaries that he's actually talking to. Because they belong to the Roman Curia, he's their boss under Unum Sanctum, but he's trying to clean up the house because things falling. All right, see, issued to all members of domestic police forces, U.S. Marshal Service, the Provost Marshal, members of the American Bar Association, that's your lawyers, you see? and the American Armed Services, these organic states, when he says organic American states, he's talking about the aggregate land and the organic truth distinguished from any corporate entities constructed thereafter. In other words, everything is layered. All you have thereafter, after the 61 thing, is imposters, identity theft, misrepresentation, and non-degere. All the brain systems are non-degere. Negro, black, colored, Indian, Latino, all of those are non-degere. No such people whatsoever. All of those people are descendants of Amerindians, Moors, descendants of Moroccans, born in America, heirs to the world's largest estate who have been under European colonial occupation, i.e. under the Unum Sanctum Hegemony, that's also referred to as the Spanish Inquisition. That is the foundation of all the politics, all of the contemporary politics, North and South, world over. Therefore, how do you distort? You've got to give people something to think about, something to be busy, so they introduce connotative linguistics. And this is where people don't understand prepositional phrases. They don't teach law and history together when they go together. All of these fundamentals, so the people, even in their intelligence, come out into the world handicapped. And then, like as you can see, after they murdered Queen Winona in Philly, 1902, they set up the General Education Board, and the dark priesthood said honestly what they were going to do. It's public. Doesn't John D. Rockefeller and Frederick T. Gates say that they're going to dump these people down? Yeah. And don't these people keep sending their children to them? Then they give them nanoviruses to make them sick. Mm. Now they got, you see people now walking around 35, 40 years old, all over Philadelphia with canes and walkers.
Yeah, that's right.
You ain't never seen this stuff before in our culture. They got high blood pressure, diabetes, strokes, cancers, everything. But they saved. you got to look at this stuff really seriously. This man's waging biological warfare, and they're so asleep they don't even know that these sicknesses are artificial. They're biological warfare. He's trying to kill off the heirs to the estate because the things is collapsing. And he got the answer to this. So how do you start removing the karmic debt? You tell them so that you get from the karmic position, you've told them. So they tell them in all kinds of movies, like True Lies with Anthony Hopkins, these people are Moors. Matrix, the Oracle, Asiatic woman. Who holds the pill? Morpheus. Mama's Prayer, where do they start? Six and more. Robin Hood, Morgan Freeman. The Moors know all the shit. they tell you over and over again. Wizard of Oz, they even tell you what they did. Right? Emerald City is your star. Emerald City. Red Ruby's slippers. In the original writing, they're silver coins for the moon. But that's red, that's for your flag. Right? Yellow Brick Road, that's the Zodiac Constitution of the Moors. Right in the City Hall in Philadelphia. When you step back, it's the Wizard of Oz. Four gates. Zodiac Constitution right in the middle of it. And that's where they do the judgment when the Mummers Prayer ends. They end at Masonic Lodge right there. Got Georgie's pictures, big as day. All the gates, Moorish, clear, they don't hide it. You see what I'm saying? The cornerstones in the grave pit, right in the dark north, beneath the parapet, they got Asiatics holding up the pillars of Atlas, Morocco. See, all this is symbolic, even in the architecture. Then you have to the west. Go west, young man, northwest, right? The first thing you see is a fountain, then a birth canal. Then goes up to the Art Museum, which is an M from the air, major art. Then you got the Delaware and Schuylkill, fallopian tubes. Then you got Eakin Oval, right at the base of the step that Rocky runs up. Queen Winona is right there, and they show you assassination, symbolism, and it's called Eakin's Oval, ovary. It's an arc, right in your face. Then the nation's flags on each side, and then at 18th Street is the cathedral that the folks took over. 18, 3 times 6 is 18. So right there you go. They talk to you in architecture. And then they have what they call the birth of the nation. And then they show it in what? The palace. That's where it showed. We showed that in the White House. House palace. Now, Philadelphia, Sacramento is the capitolium of the legitimate United States. Still is. Washington, D.C. is a sovereign city-state belonging to the Jesuits. That's the operations for the Pope's army. But the capital is Philadelphia. Still is. People come from all around the world taking pictures, and the heirs who great estate selling drugs to each other on the corner don't even know they think they came from someplace else. With the help of their black leader guys who are really overseers. So that takes the debt off of Rome from a spiritual perspective. Because they know that you can't violate divine law without a response. You can do legislation stuff, call it, you know, all day long. But they know these people don't know the difference between legislated law and the common law, which is the bridge that attaches you to the divine law or the hermetic law that is universal. The seven hermetic rules. You see? So, how do you remove the debt? Next Thursday, I'm going to punch you right in the forehead and take your sneaks. Next Thursday.
Oh, damn! You will be surprised at how did they do this?
I told you he was going to do it. Whether you was listening or not. If you pay attention to the European, even when they dropped them buildings, they told people in 92. They even printed on the fiat. We need to just fold it. Seems like we lose a karmic debt. Some of it. But let's not go there. Let's go with the heirs. What are we supposed to do for the last 202 years? Over and over again, you're telling people to be themselves. They still want to follow money. Be themselves. They want to follow these black leaders. They're getting ready to exterminate. That's why we're doing this adverse coming. It's not new. This is not a new lesson. It's just a little bit more focused in some areas that I know that will put a nail in the wound's coffin. You know, because I can't tell you everything. If I tell you everything, I would be irresponsible. You have to go into your divine mind and pull out the rest, because it has to be yours. It can't be somebody else's. Because every man, every woman, and every child, even, must confess their own. Can't confess it for you. We can try to show you, try to wake you up. However, once you've been told, understand that you're responsible. And if you don't act on it, everything that you have is justifiably taken from you, and it will be, so you'll recognize it when you see it happen. However, my issue is to try to slow it down, try to choke the dragon. You know, we see trying to gobble over everybody on and put some fish bones in his food. Big fish bones in his food. Kind of hard. You know that cartoon they had where, I think it was this, stork was carrying the frog or something like that, and you see the frog choking the stork. He was flying and he was choking, and he said, let go of my throat, I can't breathe. And he was saying, no, it was a vulture, stork or a vulture. Because the frog knew that if he released his throat, that he was going to eat him. You know, that's the whole point. But the real deal, I know that the active adverse claim will start choking the dragon, which is why I've been putting it out for years. And also I call it reversion and reversionary. And reconveyance. That's why I did that rally document in 211 when he was trying to sell all these people's houses and put it in 211. That's why guys don't want to talk to me. Whenever I had went to a wrong meeting and I kind of saw what they were doing, and I went home and stayed up all night and did a reversionary and rally thing, went back the next day and was passing it out. Newspaper was there. I think her name was Denby.
Judge Dandy wasn't going to give them a continuance. Yeah. Congress wasn't helping them. So the next week, South Congress sent, they sent representatives up, gave $106 million trying to help the homeowners, like, well, they ain't homeowners, but the deal with this. And Dandy gave them a continuance, which she said she wasn't going to do. So that kind of messed them up around a little bit, you know. But it's understanding what's going on. So the deal of it is when you become conscious, if the body would act on their own, the dragon dies. It's just that the people are slow or in park or don't comprehend what this really is. And then you have enough people who really know this information who have been constantly misrepresenting this information and misrepresenting what Duvalier really did. And so you have people that are caught in dogma thinking that they're satisfying their obligation to themselves. And they're really being kept busy by COINTELPRO operators. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? So I know that some of the things that I've given you, that if you research them for yourself, you will find what it is. And then you will start pushing energy out. That thought. It is that thought that I'm looking for. I don't need you to know what I'll feel. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Because
yeah.
I already know it's what chokes the dragon, because he's asked, but we know that spirit is breath. However, on a connotative level, on this layer, people, so I'm qualifying you. It's a spiritual war. But its reflection is in the dimensional third. And the people, most of them, are unable to think on multi-levels. However, that's the secret that the priesthood have over you. They're not more powerful than you. It's just that they know real Kabbalistic science, and the masses have been given dogma, so they think they're spiritual. It's really mind control. So when they try to, in their mind, be spiritual and trying to fight, be laughing. Because he know they don't know what they're doing, because he gave it to them. And they sit around, I'm calling Allah and take your sandwiches back. And Prabhupada, Bismillah, I'm going to kick your keister back. And then I call on Jesus, get thou away from me, get off my peanut butter sandwich. He's going to take all your stuff. Because he gave that to you. Now, the books themselves are not frauds. They've been misrepresented to the people. And all of those leader guys, all of them have been part of this fraud to a different degree or another. And others have been part of it because they didn't speak up. Not because they didn't know this. They didn't want Rome to take them out. So which means they chose Rome over Allah, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, Confucius, while claiming they fear no one but Allah. No, they fear Rome. Rome is their God. They refuse to call him, so to save their dignity, they won't say, my great white father. They say, the white man. Which means sovereign. They don't get pissed off when he acts like it. Like they don't know what that really means. All scholars know it means sovereign. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Then you want to march all over the place and disturb the peace. No, sir. No, I'm serious. While claiming to be spiritual, people of doo-doo. And somebody needs to call them to heart. However, knowing that most of them are dishonest, you got to try to save the coming generations by getting information out there that will liberate them from this whole paradigm. 80 to 90% of what they think they know is bullshit and twisted and misrepresented. Even they don't even know who they are, they're going to tell you about Jesus. They need to stop. And all they need is some information, not a criticism, not a knock. They need some information. Because once they start going into their honesty, sincerely, Mother Nature, just like the sun does with a seed, if you put it in the earth, if the earth is good, sun, moon, and Venus do their job. You ain't got to judge anything. Don't judge anything. Just plant the seed. Don't stand there looking at it. Go find something to do. That's what Rome don't want you to figure out. That is very simple.
That's right.
They want you to think it's complex.
See, what you gotta do You gotta sign this right here, I'm saying. And if you sign right here and authenticate this instrument, you can get your hands on the 62B Trust Act that we started in 1666. And get your hand in this bottomless pit of this global estate trust. Whether you use a CUSIP number or the marriage certificate number or the birth certificate number, and we'll give you a nice red apple. Don't bite it.
That's why we want this. And that's why I did that. Dangers of the UCCs in 66, because they want you to contract with them. And as soon as you contract with them, you made a pact. And then you go so far, and they'll let a few of them look like they win, then they'll change the rules. Oh, yeah, but you forgot to file this 8171 issue with the other issue that you were supposed to file when you did the claim with the IRS with the nine-digit number, and you didn't do like this. And your left finger wasn't in your right ear, over here. I've been doing this for like 3 years. I mean, damn, we got 3,500, and then I got this far. And then, I made a claim. Just like that European woman that they locked up last month or month before.
Heather Tucci.
As soon as she completed the cycle, they tried to disappear her. And if it wasn't for the public being aware of this going on, they would have disappeared her. But enough conscious people were on to this or in the platform that recognized that she was taken. Who were doing the same thing. But that's what I'm saying to you. But I already knew they was going to do that. Which is why you never see any push to UCCs, though I know they're in operation. I know that's the platform. However, a right of claim for a true heir unconditional in your proper person supersedes anything that they created thereafter. Because that was only introduced as an operative platform after the coup d'etat. When the Congress set up for their private self a kingship oligarchy. So logically they're doing human trafficking with human capital. It's a commercial venue. So they adopted the existing ancient rules of commerce. Of course, they had to do a little bit of battling with different people. That's why they later became uniform. They were just commercial codes. In 66, 68, they became uniform after they blackmailed those who were resisting in Texas. All right? That's when they became uniform. So this is contemporary stuff. People need to know that. So you see people that when people get a little bit of this information, they get them while they're halfway.
Give me 3,500. See, you're going to do this UCC financial state filing and stuff. And we're going to get your hand into this bottomless pit account and set off and discharge all of your cookies.
Sounds good because in theory it's supposed to work. But what they've done is just diverted you from what you should really be about. Refuting all of it. Charge them with fraud. Be patient. Choke the beast, because all this stuff will come into you. Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven, and all other things will be added unto you. Most people don't have the patience. So they're trying to get their cookies now. All they're doing is giving wrong time. And that's how he's using the UCCs. Because people are under the impression that that is the setup of the operative government all the time. It is not. That began in earnest after 1871, February 2nd, for human trafficking.
Now I'm all good.
Are we clear? Now, on the other point, and one of the things that we were going to go into is Article 3. And, of course, we're not going to go into it right now, but some of these things I'm talking about is the regulation of notes, promissory notes, et cetera, under Article 3 of the Uniform Commercial Code, because you need to know what they're operating under, even whether, you need to know the chess pieces. So, and I've been hesitant to go there because people have a tendency to take it and then run with it and then get out there and get hung. And they've been doing it like for years. But I already know what's going to happen to them. But so, I'm out to lunch, so you can't expect,
I'm not expecting people to go along with what I said, because I can see it. But I know other people, some can, some can't. Or some unwilling to see. Because all humans are psychic. It's just that most people choose not to go into that energy. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? But it's already there for everybody to see. And if they would pay attention to language, things people say, even if they weren't appreciating that, just look at trends, don't interject your biases, and look at trends and then look at the math, and even the math will tell you. That's how nature works. See, what she doesn't tell you intuitively, in your intuitive mind, she will tell you in the mathematics and the geometry all around you. All the time. But if you're afraid or not willing just to be honest to yourself, you won't see anything. And that's how you keep getting blindsided. So I know that most people are asleep, so I'm not arguing, don't just give them keys. Take the keys and kick one's ass. So if you stop, because he's accelerating all foreclosures around and gentrifying. You understand what I'm saying to you? Because what he's trying to do, they're trying to sell everybody's estate to satisfy their debts to China. All right, because they got all them ships sitting out there off Los Angeles, that's out there. That got, some of them got Christmas before Christmas stuff on them, because they're not taking UST bonds. All right, but anyways, let's go through this again. Let's look at this. See that United States of America lion? See that? Look at that. I want you all to look at that. See that third line? The United States of America, major, right? So when they talk about the United States of America, major is referring to more or less the organic. All right, that's the political platform distinguished from the organic land, but in relationship to it in its operations. Are we clear? All right, so let's go down a little bit more. The United States of America major, same thing, stationed in North America. Now you notice how the is separated from the land? You need to understand that at all times. Because most people can't even think in that layer. And that's only two layers. Are we clear? Mm-hmm. 50 organic states, United States major, you see? And the republic must be distinguished from the democracy. See the republic? The fifth line? All right. Libra Code, get used to that because that's used in international law. That's where they drafted off what you call the rules of war that are used today. It comes off that, but that's, you know, it's a subject matter within itself. And as you can see, Abraham Lincoln was the last Republican president. So now you're not fooled because you know all presidents after that were actually private CEOs for the United States Service Corporation. They are all de facto.
Libra.
Are we clear?
Libra code.
Say Libra codes. Yeah, you got this on your flash drive, so you'll be able to do research on it. Now, see here, since no orders executive or otherwise issued by Barack H. Obama pretending authority on the land, so now we're talking land jurisdiction, because we already know that all of their operations of the United States Service Corporation that Lincoln had bankrupted in 1860 are actually operating on the Admiralty Maritime jurisdiction there in the middle of the sea. So in order to be in harmony with that, that's why their headquarters is in Puerto Rico off the organic plan. Mm. Are we clear?
Clear.
All right. Now, so the President of the United States, see that capitalized, and then corporation, and nor as President of the United States of America minor. Those are two different corporation shells. The other one was one, the organic one was one that Lincoln bankrupted. But that was the service corporation distinguished from the land. You see, that's why the Pope distinguished the United States from the land. It says operating at North America. But North America is Morocco, you see. See, that's how, so you have to understand that. All right, now, Mr. Obama is president of a governmental services corporation.
Gas Service Corporation out of Lincoln, bankrupt in 1860, that's been operating under all these shells, pretending to be the government. You see? So why are they pissed at Obama? Because he went and showed the real American flag. The Al-Moroccan flag. That's where you see him when he went to Egypt and he exposed that the American Constitution comes from Muslim law. Then he shows the Al-Moroccan flag, the Moorish flag, the red flag, five-pointed green star, and they cut out the trading banner in the picture. It's in the picture. They cut it out. They crop it out. Then she wears a red dress. And then just before that, she went to the Alhambra. These are signals. Then they came back and signed the rights of indigenous people, where these people play their nationality. And remember the year before, Rahm Emanuel did what he did? All right, so see how all these signals? So they really pissed at him, because he flattened the platform. But he had to carry out what his assignment is. So Obama's really a double agent. All right, now, and of course, you know they want to do their FEMA thing. Now, you see the United States all caps? That's the other show. You not see the other one, third letter, third line, United States of America minor? See, so a governmental services corporation under contract to provide stipulated services to the organic states, and it's on their payroll. This is the platform where the twist comes in, and this is what Lincoln bankrupted in 1860, which is another reason of his assassination. You see? And so the United States Services Corporation has been fronted as the nation since 1861. And who believes it more than the heirs who keep talking about, I'm a U.S. citizen?
Civil rights.
Civil rights, let us pray. One of these days, people will rise and all that kind of crap. Let me vote under the 14th Amendment. Type stuff. Call and tell corporations. Anyway, so you don't have to figure this out because the Pope is telling you, but if you don't have, y'all have, but I'm just saying, with many of our people who really, whose so-called leaders, imams, rabbis, grand sheikhs and ministers, who are charged with telling them this, ain't telling them, they're still sitting thinking that the United States is a country, that they came from someplace else. Meanwhile, the Europeans are liquidating their estates as fast as they can. And he's going to steal their bank accounts. That's how it's going to revolution 2748 or 4827. Well, we told you about this years ago. Look at your records and see. They're going to steal all your stuff. They're going to do a bail-in. And the major reason why, even though everything is going in that direction, the main reason why they want people to do the digital stuff so they can just shut all your accounts out.
Yeah.
And then say it was hacked, so they don't have to go through all these programs.
Why?
Excuse me. Go ahead.
Islam. Speaking on that same thing, I was thinking today in terms of all these so-called alleged hacks, like with Experian and the various credit. I feel like that is being a setup. It's a setup so that when they start taking stuff, they can
let
say.
Just as a reminder to all of you. Reminder to you, all of you, NASA has the encode numbers of all of the Bitcoin operations. NASA does. So I guess you know ahead of time. I'm just telling you ahead of time. They think we can't see them. I repeat. Yes, we are.
Okay.
NASA has the encode numbers to all the Bitcoin systems. And the that interruption is because, although they didn't take it serious at first, because it's taking headway, and it's going to collapse their system quicker, and so what they're trying to do is they're trying to get in on it so they can neutralize all the others that set those systems up. Some of them operate. Most of them will fail. And those who invest, they will kill them so that they're still robbing them, just like they did on the 2748. In other words, devalue. You invest on your finance trying to run away from the petrodollar, and then they kill the Bitcoin value. The dealers, they want to still control. Say it again.
Like they did with the dinar.
Same old thing. No, but they cashed that out years ago.
Yeah.
Although it still has validity, but just not the way people think. It's sort of like they got them to invest in, but the value was still there. Now it's
went down.
All right. Now keep this in mind. Let's go down to this. Now you notice here, now again, the adverse claim is because all those people that you've been thinking are governors are just actors under the unsanctioned policy. See, so you can, if you read between the lines, you can see. We direct the Joint Chiefs of Staff to communicate these first two general civil orders directly to Mr. Obama, the members of the U.S. Congress, the administrators of all federal agencies, the members of the Supreme Court, and those acting as quote-unquote governors to compel their rapid understanding and cooperation. So you can see they're forcing them to try to act right. See, because this whole platform has been in operation since the early 1800s.
Right.
The masses are already rooted in the fraud, so they don't, they every time they come out of their mouth, they can say, the government, the judge, the officer, the positive participle, which assigns them the trust law on the spot. This is why we gotta change our language. Are we clear?
Clear.
All right, now, but let's go down here. And of course, you see in this paragraph, because y'all got this on the flash drive, so you already know, so just examine it. And so you can see, actually, they're hiding behind the IMF. So the Manchurian order kind of has taken over that for them, so that kind of knocks that out of the box. That's why the IMF is starting to build a building in China.
Right.
Because they're going to move to China. So Europeans, when people start waking up here, proclaiming everything, start messing with their bonds, they're choking a dragon. What they did was they start accelerating foreclosures. They own the books for foreclosures. They just slowed them down so the people wouldn't be alarmed what they were really doing. You know what I'm saying? So they got blocks waiting already to hit you real quick, which they're probably going to do between December and April in this area. You know, during the fire month or something like that.
Peace, brother. But so the adverse claim is it's necessary, and we don't have that much time.
Because you need to know what's happening. This is what's happening. If you can think in your mind heirship, trust, estate, you have a bunch of heirs that, one, don't know they're heirs. Two, when they find out, they're behind the learning curve because people who should have been telling these things to them decades ago have not told these things to them. Not that they're not intelligent. Their language will indicate that they got training wheels on, which means they can be declared incompetent, which gives the European corporate state operators leeway. They already know that's coming. This is why kind of is ramping up on them. You want, because they already know they're going to try to starve these people out. If you got Social Security, by the time April comes, you're lucky if you get 30% of whatever you're getting now. If you got some kind of 401k, it's a 409k.
It's a massive devaluation.
I'm telling you. Reality. We're telling people this so that they can, while they can do something, that they can stock up, put some water away, because they're going to starve you out. They're going to cut all major programs, like welfare to the poor stuff, type stuff. One of the things, they called me from the studio in Houston, right? They're disappearing people. That's what we're doing to FEMA camps. They tell them they're going someplace and they ain't seeing them no more. Some people are catching on. Thing in Florida, they held the thing over there and they were blocking highways, blocking people who were coming in to help. Europeans will tell you that. Europeans will tell you that. They've been seeing floating bodies with bullet holes going out to the Gulf. They're letting them flood out. That's why another reason they kept them storms there. The people that were bringing food in,
As a matter of fact, it was some Europeans that was coming from all over the country, and they would pick up trucks and start helping to bring food in to help the people, and they were interrupted by a few alleged federal agencies. They took them down, they bought Baton Rouge and that area and stuff like that, and, you know, to they waylaid them and say they're going to take them in the back route so they don't go through the main highways where the storms are. Then when they got them there to the big parking lot, they left them and threw them there on their own. They're going to bust that dam. It's going to be 4 feet of water. And so they went to high ground. These are Europeans. You start talking to Europeans, you know, because they're getting desperate too.
Right.
You understand? But the deal is our people's a real target. They're trying to do the same thing they did with Katrina, with that war. You steal that land? All right, but let's get through that. Let's go back.
So, my Moorish national name is Blue Nile Bay.
Yeah.
And I'm an heir to the estates of Almexum, America, North Bay. When I'm making my adverse claim for a mortgage,
when
in a mortgage argument.
In a mortgage argument, adverse claim. That. Now, let's be clear for you. Because you can think this out, because you already have a certain skill set that many people need to come to. But just to make you clear, an adverse claim ongoing stops the process of them making any more derivative on the claim, but you want to command the note back.
Okay.
You send your signature.
And then you want to state for the record, pending you removing your signature, it's called rescission of signature.
Okay.
All right? You want to get that on the record. Because as long as you don't do that, remember what I told you. In the deed of trust, you have a confessed judgment that already is operative from the beginning. It's already been in operation. So technically, you're already in latches. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? In regards to what your argument is.
It never read deed of trust.
So, yeah.
Here, deed of trust.
Yeah. Oh,
all
right. Here, put this check
back in there.
She's using that for a page divider.
By page divider on the right hand side.
Okay. All right, and get in the mic and read clearly.
Deed of trust.
Okay. Yes.
All right.
Deed of trust, an instrument in use in many states, taking the place and serving the uses of a common law mortgage, by which the legal.
So immediately they're letting you know that you're not under common law. So if you're not under common law, what law are you under? Feudal law. So, in feudal law, do they recognize a lodeal claim?
No.
So therefore, that mortgage is a sharecropping agreement, isn't it? Continue to read. Go ahead.
By which the legal title to real property is placed in one or more trustees to secure the repayment of a sum of money or the performance of other conditions.
Mm-hmm.
Bank v. Pierce.
Oh, you ain't got it.
Yeah, no, it's
the state with the substance. Mm-hmm. All right, so how many people that have mortgages have never even read what a deed of trust is? Or not even be aware that they're not in the common law, but they're assuming they are. So under feudal law, right of property is not acknowledged or recognized, is it?
No.
That's what the U.S. democracy platform is, a feudal law platform. They've been operating under the democracy order for the demons since 1861. At what point do these people think that mortgage and any agreement that they made with these people has any moral or ethical legitimacy or right of claim in it? So what happens if they're not in their proper person, if they're not heirs? Because remember, if you're not an heir, you can't enforce the Constitution and treaty because they're covenants.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It must be identified. Identifiable, meaning that like this. Let's keep it simple. You're Russian, representative of Russia. you're Brazil. You're China, China, right? She's Zimbabwe, right? You're Sierra Leone. You're doing some deal with Russia. But you're gonna have a treaty. But you have a treaty with them. They will become liaison for the enforcement of your agreement, like a go-between. Likewise, so if you understand that, do you understand the problem that a lot of these sovereignty groups are having, that the Europeans are having, when they start talking about they states, citizen, state, sovereign, citizen, Christian, sovereign, and then magistrates are telling them, you can't use that constitution as a defense. You're not a party to it. Oh, you're denying my constitutional rights. White people ain't no part of that constitution. It was Moors and Deists. Those Deists' names were John Adams, Benjamin Franklin, Thomas Jefferson, who all had Korans, by the way, in treaty, called Treaty of Peace and Friendship, that supersede that constitution,
that's right,
which is the Supreme Law of Land. Now, you either their descendants or you one of their adopted citizens under the Naturalization Act that Ulysses Grant modified in 1870. But you said you white guy. You can't use that either. See why the Europeans are scared now? See, you've got to understand contract law and treaty law. Constitution and treaty are one document. All contracts and agreements entered into before the adoption of this Constitution shall be binding against the United States under this Constitution as under Confederation. And all treaties made which shall be made in pursuance thereof shall be the supreme law of the land, and every judge of every state shall be bound thereby. Any laws or constitution of any state to the contrary,
notwithstanding,
at what point they don't get it? And half these people never read that constitution, but they're going to talk about the law.
But
you get the whole point, then they go hire a barrister, and he screws them, then he want to march again. Do you understand what our problem is? Concept. What we're trying to do is get everybody focused. This stuff is not so complicated. It's that people are scattered. And the concepts are wrong. They don't know fundamental law. What is the supreme law of land? Third grade civics. The Constitution for the United States of North America. Under treaty and the Northwest Ordinance of 1787, determining the formation of government, coming out of the Treaty of Peace and Friendship, the world's longest running treaty, which Obama went to Egypt and told you about. What do these people need? Somebody lay on the railroad tracks for them? So if they want to deal with belief systems, they're going to find themselves cooked in a few minutes. Because this European is liquidating. And if anybody's hanging on, and these gangers about their marching and stuff like that, and thinking that you're going to do the old walk style type stuff, they got sonic weapons. They don't even need a lot of troops like they used to. They got just regular cars with more like ordinary antennas, and they're using sonic waves on their brains and stuff. They're going to give them tumors and a whole bunch of stuff, catching them later.
Question.
Go ahead.
Why is it necessary to rescind a straw man signature on an adverse claim?
All right. Because that is an estate, it's not you. And they're claiming access to Global Estate Trust, and you did not make the clarification. So they're going to pull your body with it. And since you already did, now they're justified to kill you in FEMA camps. Because according to the law, it's civil little more too. What's your identity? I'm black, you're already dead. I'm Negro, you're already dead. Color, you're already dead. Remember unum sanctum. Unum sanctum, the Moors are declared dead until proven otherwise. It's just that they've been enforcing it on their own as of late, since 33.
Does your proclamation prove that you're not dead?
Is that not an adverse claim?
That's right.
That means it's going, isn't it?
That's right.
What happens if you don't interject it? In a foreclosure, listen to this. Keep this in mind. If I didn't say it, I'm saying it now. Whenever there's an action against the estate, it's called foreclosure, action against the estate. That's why all foreclosures are called abandonments, because you're dealing with an estate. All right? Right of defense, automatic and mandatory in all foreclosure proceedings, is known as an adverse claim. If no one steps up, their position stands. Straw man is an estate. Because it is an estate. Why did they do an estate? So that they won't be charged with human trafficking. If you say it's you, now you've accepted their death. You see, it's just like a catch-22 type thing. That's why I say the dangers of the UCC. It's not that it's not supposed to be operative, but it's an offer that actually buys in time for people that are a little more not sleep. When you're waking up to this, oh, they gotta give you something.
Right, so you can't exist within duality. Once you
meaning that you must separate
your Morris
identity. This is why years ago we always taught people when they're speaking of a straw doing X rel position.
Yeah.
X relational.
Right.
But you need to know what you're saying and why you're saying it. Because anytime they get you to say that's my versus, you just do all the rest of your conversation. My marriage, like, my driver's license, all these are bank bonds. They need to tie you to the straw, to the dead. So when they drive the dead body, you drag with it. This is why all so-called crimes are commercial. Because they're dealing with the dead. The other thing that I want you all to remember this. This is law. Another way to beat them. It is unlawful for them to speak for a third party, particularly of a dead man. This is why all law says that they cannot speak for a third party, but no one usually speaks up. So like you in one of the venues and they force you in there for a ticket. They say, City of Wilmington, and an officer, I said that you were riding up the side of the building like this, and you made a left turn near that window. And therefore, you were in violation of peanut butter, cracker jacks, that's 2301, you said. Right? And that'll be a fine, you know, 6 months or 6 days, and then I'm going to have a different thing, stuff like that. Say, oh, wait a minute. Yeah, Clearfield doctrine, you talking human trafficking here. You representing the national government or some private affairs for the barristers of England. Oh, well, you should better stop saying stuff like that. We'll talk later. Sit down there. And we're going to talk for a minute. You're going to really get me upset now. You know, stuff like that. You know, once you understand what's up, you kind of know you gotta start throwing wrenches in the gears. Because they need your permission to throw you off the plank.
I have a question real quick.
You can start.
The question I have is in a case where someone sends you a document states that the mortgage has been sold. From one
all right,
to the
now,
next.
Yes, now stop right there so we don't go real deep, right? Because I know you have more to add, but let's just do this. Oh, Widowbearer, protest, here's my defense and adverse claim. Stop the negotiations, pending my rescission of signature. And sign all rights reserved, heir to the estate.
In the form of an affidavit?
Yeah. You don't do a motion because they can dismiss it.
That's right.
Yeah. See, the reason I'm saying this is because you need to understand this is put it this way. And I can't emphasize it enough. That's why I said I didn't want to get into a whole bunch of other details. I'm trying to stay focused where the head of the nails are. I don't want to look at the whole pin. I want you to focus on the point. You know what? Worry about how the pin slips up, and you know how you have a pin, and you slip up and put it in this casing. No, let's focus on the pin. Let's start sticking the glue in the band. Yeah, but what about the other side? Yeah,
deal with that later. It's supposed to be dependent. Right?
Would that come under the 9 months that you're talking about?
Does no,
that
seem this to is the 9 months. See, we're going to go into really clear. The promissory note, think like this, a cocoon and a butterfly, right? A cocoon, we can have it like this, and as a matter of fact, they used to do this with little children. They used to collect cocoons and stuff like that, and then children take them and put them in like a fish bowl with a little leaf and a little branch and a little water and stuff like that, and they tie it to the branch, and the children in school, and they wait for a while, and then they have the temperature, you know, regulated in the schoolroom. And then one morning, the children come in, and they see a couple of butterflies flying around in the room, in the classroom. So the cocoon, at one point, you know, because it usually happens when the movement of the moon, that's how everything operates like that. And then they see these little butterflies, and the children, ooh, and then they see them, look, he's coming out, he's coming out, and his feathers coming out, and his wings is coming out. This is what it is in law. A note that you memorialize or put your signature on is presented to the servicer. Servicer is those who are promising to give you $250,000 for the house, to buy whatever you're going to buy, car, whatever, blah, 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 blah. Same principle. So, you give them the note. They're supposed to give you the $250,000 after you sign. And in the promissory note, they hold the note for you to pay them back. In law, the note comes to maturity in 9 months. 1 hour thereafter, it goes from the cocoon to the butterfly. It's a totally different instrument, though it's the same thing. In law, it is no longer a note. It is now a security. Now, key. What they've been doing is taking your note, and that's plural, packaging them or bundling them and securitizing them even before their maturity, converting them into a security, and then selling them to investors, then getting the finance plus other finances for these bundled dead pledges because they declared you dead. Now they assign themselves as FOFRs or trustees. So they get paid already. Meanwhile, anything that you give them in the name of this transaction is called the bonus. From then on, it's a gift. Because when you memorialize it, it was already paid for because unbeknownst to you, the Pope set up a global estate trust after they defeated the Moors in Granada and set up the global estate trust that runs all Western Hemisphere economies, the fall of the Moroccan Empire. This is the fact, right? So now, hold on. Let's back up to that instrument. They never gave you the 250. So they sold your note, which is supposed to be returned to you after maturity. And whatever spoils from it, they're supposed to compensate you because they didn't really give you any finance. But instead, they got paid for it, then use that finance, and then they put you on the books as owing them this $250,000. But they took your note in violation of process, made it a security in violation of law, monetized it, which they wouldn't have got monetized if they hadn't bundled this thing, and then put you on the debtor claim when you're at the point that they bundled it. At that point, it became a security and an asset for them. It was monetized, made fungible. Therefore, you are credited their whole operation. Now you're the creditor, but they put you in the books as the debtor. They still ain't gave you shit. And hold you on the hook for that. Now, in the deed of trust, they have hidden in there what's called a confessed judgment. And a confessed judgment, at any time, they can be an administrator of it, can do what they want to do with it.
You see, so it's already technically foreclosed from the beginning. Meanwhile, get themselves off the hook. They'll usually sell it to another servicer, and in 3 or 4 months, you get a mail, and you got a new mortgage holder, blah, 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 you know. So they're getting paid twice, they're getting double dipping, right? Now, I mean, all payments that you're sending them, they send to a servicing pool. This is where companies and investors, they have what you call a servicing pool, like the DDTC in New York type stuff, seed company. You understand? And they're actually holding all the title. You think you got title. No, you got a certificate of title. Same thing with your cars. They do the same trick with your cars. You understand? The original manufacturer title is, and they send it to those persons acting as governors who are already deputy-nice, and they send it to corporate headquarters, Washington, D.C. Then they send it to seed company, New York, and then it goes on the stock market. See, everybody is doing the human trafficking, and it don't seem like it. This goes for everything, even beyond your mortgages. But keep this in mind, this is the key. When you went to closing, they presented to you that you were closing the deal. Contract law, when you signed it, that closed the deal. So the closing is really a secret and undisclosed renegotiation of the loan that you already closed already. At this point, they made you a third party, hidden party to the pooling company that they've been sending your payments to. Are we clear? So in law, that makes now, because it's no longer a note, it's a security, now you're in contract law. So that makes you a proprietary holder of interest in that note. Because that's what generated the finance. In other words, the investors wouldn't have gave them crack. They hadn't gave them, you know, they ain't gave you nothing yet. So, without your monograph on that instrument, they have nothing. Therefore, you have positive proprietary interest. So all you have to say, y'all ain't played fair. I'm rescinding my signature. So now it's pending, because now you just stopped the negotiation, because you're a proprietor holder, because the instrument is no good without your signature. Not theirs, yours. What point you don't understand that? And it's not a note, it's a security. And they didn't return your note, so now it's time to stop the bull crap. I want my note back. And I want all records of all receipts, transactions, etc., on this instrument, security, because it's my stuff. It don't say Freddie Jones. It says Bosnachwald Binkledink. That's my name. You know, you understand the same thing. So, rescission of signature, because remember, fraud has no statute of limitation. And since they misrepresented and made you a third party to a contract without your permission, that is called a rightful defense in an adverse claim, which is an automatic when there's a foreclosure. It's an automatic, except if you don't invoke it.
By invoking it, I'm contacting the people who had it before.
You got that correct.
Contacting
you got that?
The people who they sent it to. And
that put them on notice. Yes, this is what we talked about before.
Do I report it at the county reporter's
yes.
office?
Yes.
Okay.
You tell everybody. That's what Rick did. Okay. When we told you about Rick, when the IRS was coming after this, that's the whole point. But I didn't have to argue with Rick because he's Chinese, and I didn't have to talk to him for 3 years telling him he ain't yellow people. But with our people, you know, before you can even tell them about nationality and birthright, you got to convince them that they ain't black. Because every second sentence they come out, and we black people, you know, the argument's over. They keep going right back into the pit. You understand what I'm saying to you? So it's no need for you to be talking about the state, because they think you're a business of crayons. They're totally their state property by their own agreement. Then you can tell them, declare your nationality. Yeah, that's interesting. I'll get around to it. And so they don't have an ongoing adverse claim, you know, and we give them stuff. Study this so you can understand the history. Oh, that's interesting, but I got to go to the mosque right now. I'll talk to you later.
You read that stuff I gave you last year? Well, I started, but and this is how it works. Meanwhile, the European liquidates their estate. And it goes on all the time. Meanwhile, opportunists are going to sell them some packages when they're not totally waking up. They're waking up, they ain't totally there. Opportunists on both sides of the path. The man, you know what I'm saying? I say it's packages and stuff, and what we're going to do is authenticate your man's certificate, your credit certificate, QCIC number, and you're going to get your hand, put your gloves on now, and this file is going to count. And discharge all your peanut butter sandwiches. And they get distracted. When all they gotta do is make an adverse claim. But they better be an improper person when they do it. It is not complex. People keep making it complex. What you do, you stop the process. Then you make a claim. See, this keep this in mind, everybody. Adverse claim is not unlike an estoppel. Not unlike a rebuttal and then a claim of reversion of a state. Look at that, look at them all synonymous. Which is why I put them on the board when we first started, because you've got to be thinking multiple levels. You've got to know what's happening. You can't be estimating what's happening because your language will get contaminated. You'll start throwing things in there how you feel. That's the worst thing to do. Feelings is incompetence.
Well, you know what I really mean, because it's common to know, because Jesus don't like ugly and sandwiches. Yeah.
Like they told Prince when we start talking about God, I don't like ugly and sandwiches. I ain't got your contract. Now that you've been smart, now you can't use your name either. Do you understand what we need to, get real to realize what's really been going on here on this planet? Your beliefs don't mean a damn thing. They gave them to you to keep you busy while you get raped. Then they got overseers in your community saying, Jesus, God, Allah, Moses, Muhammad, keeping you busy, giving you half the truth. Did Prophet Muhammad, when he was on the scene, say there'll be no secularism in Islam? How many sects they got? About 78? Well, it goes on and on and on. Then they ran him out of Mecca. And they don't listen to Muhammad. They listen to, he listened to the scientists to call Hadith. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? They ran Yahshua out. He said, I come amongst my own. They receive me not. Translation, they don't want to hear it. Okay. We're getting ready to close out. Anyway, I just want to say, Islam to you.
Islam.
You're abundantly beautiful.
Thank you.
You give me an abundant hug right now.
Thank you so much.
And she got the abundant food over there, so I want you all to abundantly get unhungry. Anyway. I want to thank Dr. Nyilo, you know, for maintaining this house. Will you give her a hand, please?
Yes.
Yeah. And those who are listening, make sure that I'm still buying, you know, the 250 Nikes, buy the 100 Nikes, and make sure you send her a little donation. Keep the house open, because in the real world, until we conversion is, you know, reversed, you still got to keep the house rolling. But anyway, just keep in mind, sis, everything is predicated on your heirship. Therefore, this is why they say your signature or your monograph is the goal. It's not that it isn't. It's because you're dealing with estate law. And as they've been screwing you, all you have to do is make it clear in documented form and in oral that stop the operations, stop all negotiations, pending my rescission of signature on that note. Meanwhile, I want it back. And because you monetize it in violation of due process, and Ford has no statute of limitation, stop. Fix it. Give my stuff. And what happens? Whatever they got set up, the derivatives start crushing. They start folding up. Just like in the Wizard of Oz, when you see the houses come from the sky, in my father's house with many mansions, fall down on the wicked witch, and her stocks curl up, and the ruby slippers transfer onto Dorothy's feet. Okay. But they're telling you. And then they say, God, stop the stuff. your home. You just bumped your head. Recision of signature, adverse claim to counter Uno Sanctum hegemony operations at the North Gate, because they have been the keepers of the North Gate unto the heirs. Our people have their confident and awake. Declare your nationality, y'all. Peace. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you have any phones here?
Say it again.
Do you have any other phones here?
Sure.